I am a sergeant. So yeah, it's been a long time, but I got promoted to a sergeant, and I'm driving this marvelous and sexy Tahoe. So I'm gonna bring you guys with me in this patrol, and hopefully you
Oh,
guys are
hold
gonna
on.
love this live stream and episode of me being a sergeant. So yeah, let's get on it. And I'm just gonna get ready for a bit, and we'll go head to the sheriff department and get on patrol. So how have you guys been? I know so many people would say, "Oh my God, Dave stopped making videos, and I stopped making videos about Arma 3, Santos RP, GTA 4. I've been so busy, guys, and I'm really sorry about that. A lot of things have been coming up in my life right now. Recently, my cousin, applied to be a cop, and I try to help him out, go through the exam process and everything. I've been working my ass out too, and lately I've been working towards getting myself a new computer and a new monitor, which is a new TV. I just basically need a new TV. But with that being said, I'm planning on getting an Asus GTX 51 or GTO 51, the new version of the Asus desktop computers that just came out. So yeah, so like I said, I'll be bringing you guys. Oh, wrong way, wrong way. So yeah, I've been trying to get myself an Asus 50 GTX 51 with a double 1080 GTX 8 gig of GeForce. Pretty much trying to get this graphics up and get it level for you guys, and have some nice graphics when I play games, and because and I have good frames also, because the frames on my laptop now suck. So, and I've had this gaming laptop for like 6 years now, so it's just telling me it's time for me to change it. And as you guys are gonna notice some of the lags and some of the going back and forward, that that most of the car do while I'm patrolling. That's the frames I'm talking about, and that's some of the glitch on the metrics. I don't know if it's from my computer or if it's from the server, but I don't know. It's just bad. For most people, it doesn't really happen like that for them, because they got a good computer. But for me, it happens frequently because my computer sucks. So, I've been working towards changing it. My new desktop computer is going to cost almost $5,000, and that's a lot of money. My new monitor is going to be 4K, so it's going to be almost, we're talking about $400, $500, stuff like that. So yeah, I'm working towards it. Step by step, I'm going to build it up, and get it going for you guys. But I just ask for you guys to be patient with me. And almost 10:50. What I do right here, I just ask for you guys to be patient with me, while I try to get my stuff working. So obviously, so yeah, thank you for you guys joining me on this live stream. I'm gonna show you guys a lot about Fitch's Island. And yeah, Fitch's Island changed a lot. The prison is out. The Lobok actually changed a lot. Like, they fixed the roads, new pattern, and they moved most of the buildings, to some places. Oh, look at that truck. They moved most of the buildings to new places. As you guys can see, this is way different than the last of my live stream that I played. So yeah, just gonna park my towel right here in the supervisor spot, and we're gonna get going. So hold on, guys. Let me just get going right here. So how you guys doing? I missed you guys, man. You guys have been showing me so much love. Like, my channel, really went from, was it 79 subscribers the last time I checked it, to 150, guys. Jesus. I open up my YouTube channel. I'm like, Jesus, is this my channel? Like, 150 subscribers, guys. You guys are amazing. You guys are the best fans in the world right now. Like, you guys are welcome. All my new subscribers, all my new subscribers. I just want to say welcome to the Godfather's Nation, the biggest boss nation. You know what I mean? So yeah. Let me just go on duty right now, and obviously, and I'm gonna see if I can show you guys the new prison. Set my frequency. Hold on, guys. Set my frequency to 60. Ready to check?
10-2.
10-4-7-22 is gonna be going tonight. Hey, what's up, cadet?
Your office, Stacy.
Sal.
Hey, what's going on, cadet? You good? Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Yeah, so what's going on?
Much. Looking for someone to ride with.
Oh, you're looking for someone to ride with? Are you looking for someone to ride with?
Yeah.
Alright, hold on. I'm just going to get your deputy right now.
Paul 69, I'm in a foot pursuit with the suspect, I believe. He's in the Green Hills Field. Red shirt.
This is 722 to any deputy on a solo patrol. I have a cadet that needs a ride along. If you have time, can you come to SDM pick him up?
David 31 Hotel can come pick him up after the 1080. Can you read the 1020 of the foot pursuit?
Alright,
yeah, he's in the field of greenhouses, jetting around my cruiser.
10-4.
DOC, this is Sheriff's Department, over.
Be advised, we're suspects times two, blue shirt, red shirt, running in the field in front of me.
Alright, so we're trying to see where the prison is right now. Let me just pull over to the right and let's go check out the prison. Hold on, guys. Let's see if the prison is still on the main. Is that a prison?
What is heading towards the creek? No, we're still they in the field.
Moved,
they're just...
They moved the prison. I'm going to see where they put it at. Let's see. Slippery slopes.
Can I get it by location, please?
10-4, I'm arriving now.
I'm trying to see where they moved the prison to. Where's the prison? Let's see. They moved it. Oh yeah, there it is. That's the prison right there, guys. Let's go check it out. Let's go check it out. I'm going there right now. This is gonna be fun. Let me go show you guys what the prison looks like. Yeah, so for you guys that have questions, I just recently got promoted to a sergeant. You know, my hard work finally paid off, and you know, I've been supervising cadet and doing a lot of training. I've been busy. Like, I've been so busy. So, you know, it's really a huge honor, you know, for me to get to that position in Fuse Island. You know, I feel privileged and stuff like that, you know, to be able to train cadets and see them, you know, do good things when they go on patrol and actually patrol, you know, just the same way that I taught them how to do. So it's pretty much amazing, you know, getting the
case deployed, greenhouse.
I'm feeling it, you know. So, yeah, let's go see the prison and, you know, get to know what's going on in the prison, and I'll show you guys around, because I haven't done that in a while, but I can show you guys around and show you guys some few things that and how the prison works. Whoa. Okay, yeah, so for you guys that's still asking me if my driving improved, no, it didn't improve. It's been worse, because the frames I don't know if it's my, like I said, I don't know if it's my laptop or if it's the metrics. The frames are horrible right now. I'm so serious. They're so horrible. Let me see where the prison is. Oh, I'm still going there. You know, the frames are horrible. Like, horrible. Whoa, 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 look at this. Swerve. Alright, so, let me just shut up and, you know, have you guys watch me play. So currently, for those of you joining right now, we are en route to the prison. Trying to check it out and see, you know, how the prison looks. I know it's going to look beautiful. I don't know. For every one of you. Yep, we're here, prison. Yay, prison. Oh, they made the prison look so beautiful. Oh, look at this. Oh, someone come look at this. Oh, someone come look at this. Look at this. Look at this prison. Oh, this should be the best prison I've ever seen after the Australian prison in, is it Amatu? Oh, someone look at this. Look. What is he doing? How do you think your fire truck can fit in there? There's no fire in the what are you doing? Back out. Oh, look at this. Look. Someone look at a firefighter. What are you doing?
Your
fire truck is too big to get in there. Can't you realize that?
I don't see why you gotta toot your horn for that.
Hell yeah, I gotta tell you.
I'm testing these things.
Testing?
I'm dumb. I know how to drive a truck.
You don't. Because if you did, you should have realized that fire truck can get in there. Oh, look, you see? Oh, see? Guys, you see? Thank you so much.
You're
yeah, for destroying my Tahoe. Thank you, yeah. Thank you so much.
Take it to the impound lot. It's in the impound lot.
When the firefighters cause fires.
Yeah, right.
Oh, shit.
Look, so what's your name? Take it to the impound lot.
Jimmy Leahy. Jimmy and Leahy. I was trying to show my subscribers the new prison. Why?
Hold on. Wait 1 second.
Sorry, mate.
Okay, you know what? I'm sorry, guys. So before he actually moves me to the, you know, to my... Oh, he just did.
Alright. Dave, how much?
Oh, now I gotta drive back to the same place.
No,
oh,
no,
my
no,
God.
I take you back.
Oh, thanks! Woo! Alright.
So long.
Alright, guys. Let's go take the, my towel back out from the...
Taser, greenhouses.
And then he could help me out. Oh, my God. That was some bullshit that happened right now. You guys realize that was some bullshit.
Pull it out.
Let's go.
Put in the driver's seat.
Yay. Guys, watch this.
Watch
this. Oh. Okay, hold on. Yep, I'm good to go. Oh, guys, watch this. Look. Oh, we just did it. Oh, the guns are back again.
Good.
Thanks, buddy.
I apologize about the fucking thing.
Oh, guys, look at this. The guns have done it again in my life. The guns are so sweet. Like, look at that sweet teleporting, bro. We just went like it was a movie. Oh, guys, yeah, look at this. Look, someone come look at this. Look at this freeze. Oh, look at this freeze. Oh, I'm so excited right now. Like, you guys can tell. I'm so excited right now. Ah, look at this, guys. Amazing, right? I know.
Man, get your car back?
Yes, he did, unfortunately. Yeah. Yeah, I would have been...
That's funny.
Hi guys, welcome to the prison. So yeah, we have.
I was hoping to go flying.
So here we have the fun decks and.
Hi, so go through McDonald's. How can I take your order?
Here we have the fun decks with the repeating buttons because we are with the PD.
Abby, follow me.
Welcome to the prison.
Guys,
you know, this is the fun deck.
Right.
You know,
well,
when someone is arrested, we bring them in here.
Paul 6-9. Do we have any supervisors available?
We bring them in here and have them, you know, transported to prison. But we process them from the front desk. We're gonna have someone receive them and assign them to a correction officer. And then this is the training room for the corrections officer actually. So this is like a DOC sheriff department, something like that. You know, this is where the DOC kind of they hang out. The DOC officers.
Hey Jimmy.
Hold up, Pete, you can.
Sir!
Hey Vid, I definitely can't see him.
Hold up, Pete, you can't see me, that's the thing.
Hello sir, how you doing?
Alright. Alright, good Jimmy, how are you doing?
Good.
The other thing that would be nice
is let's
go
close
the door.
we need main door to open, I think Ocean has Robbie Skipper back.
Are we gonna get closed or what?
He's back here? Okay.
He's back, yeah, he's amazing. He's running around like an idiot inside SD.
Okay, I think you just have to make it smaller on his
Excuse me, is it
No, we're still visiting ours right now. No.
Four different ways, and you can't compensate for it.
Guys, look at the prison. Look at the prison.
Every time you move your arms.
You see? Cop outside the cell. Does it look like I'm taking a shit?
Man.
So
kitchen area.
Kitchen.
About the kitchen area.
It's got to be on a vest in order to not stretch. I was able to
open the hallway. Open the hallway.
Patches and the uniform rank and stuff like that, but the back, it just, I can't do anything about that.
Yeah, car is custom model. Good. Don't build it.
Yeah, it's custom.
Sweet.
Man, cell 2 open.
I got Bobby.
Boys.
Well, the unfortunate thing about the model is that it's like.
So I just showed you guys the control rooms. You know, that's a control room to the doors and everything. Simply in DOC. Let me see what.
Hey,
what
I'm sorry, but can you like do this non?
Okay, this is the this is the warden's office. So that's where the warden, you know, stays and stuff like that.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
So let me take you guys to the main prison. Let me see what's in here.
Right here, David.
Oh yeah, there we go, there we go. So this is the top of the DOC, this is the top of the prison. This is upstairs. So this is... this is...
You guys put that Robbie kid near me, I'm gonna kill myself.
I gotta whisper you a secret.
Hey Rock, can we go out in the yard?
I'm close enough for whisper.
And I'm grabbing you.
So, guys, this is simply where the DOC... deputies are going to be standing over, you know, keeping watch on the prisoners when they have opening days, you know. On the opening days is where they are opening, when they're going to open the cells and have them come out and have a little bit of fun, you know, communicate with themselves, you know, get to know each other, you know, eat and do some other stuff, you know. And this is when also food is going to be passed to them. If you can see where the where those deputies are actually standing, is where they're gonna have the food coming to the prison from that area. And yeah, so pretty much you know, that's what, you know, this is what the prison looks like. You have the control room right there. Those windows are actually tinted so no one can see through them. But yeah, so this is, you know, this is it. This is sexy as hell, right? So let me know if you guys like it, cause I do like it. I don't know if anyone else likes the prison, but I think the prison is cool. Yeah, so what else do I want to show you guys? I'm just going to go in and show you guys, you know, how it looks, pretty much. So just hold on for me, guys. Hold on for me. C. Williams, welcome, welcome. You have a question. You said, can you use an unmarked Tahoe? Oh, undercover Tahoe, please. I'm a sergeant, but I can only use a marked Tahoe. The unmarked Tahoe can be used by a lieutenant and up. So, yeah. You know. So, those are the only guys that can use an unmarked Tahoe.
Department until training
open
is completed.
Open cell 5.
Open cell 5.
Dude, you have a 12-year-old voice.
Get the fuck back here, Robbie.
So...
Fucking shoot him, Justin. Put him out of his misery now.
Get in your cell.
I'm just gonna show you guys some of the things and... Yeah, we could be on our way. Let's go downstairs. Let's go downstairs and see if there's any way we could get to the prison.
You walk your happy ass in there, Robbie. Let's go.
Oh, I was saying okay, this every, is the training room again. Considerable including these ones and the ones in the other rooms.
Okay, another room. So we have to go into the main prison, guys. So let's just go to the main prison and see what we could get.
You know what's interesting about these prisoners?
What's that?
All white.
Kane, how did we know that was gonna come out of your fucking mouth?
Still. Space.
Still. Sub 5 open.
Yeah, so they actually have a clinic close to the prison, in case you know someone gets injured or need medical help. Is someone actually peeing in the toilet or something? What the hell? Hi, Charles Xavier. Hi, Xavier. How you doing, sir? Welcome, welcome. I'm trying to go to the main DLC cell. Like someone is doing some dumb shit in there right now. Oh no, we're in the wrong area right now.
Yo, so
wait, how do we get into... Wait, let me see.
I don't really know what kind of things we can do in here.
You can sit on your bed and fap.
Wait, are we allowed to fap to black figures? Is that allowed?
Get out of my way!
Ladder clear.
Paul 69, show me 10-6, switching to my control.
I am the...
Oh my god, that sound! He's probably literally
right now,
boys. I am Mr. Sheriff Potato.
Well, you can't put yourself in your own jail cell, so...
Yeah.
I'm trying to show you guys, you know, the whole rooms right now. Just to see... Okay, that's the interrogation room, I guess. Yay, there we go.
Whiskey 1, go ahead.
Can we get a yard door open?
Shit,
this is not one. You're just gonna have to remember.
Oh my god.
10-4.
Yard door open.
We wanna see the control room.
That's upstairs.
I'd take us there.
That.
Stop knocking.
This is another door, it's this one. Interrogation room.
Another prison better than the estate. Jesus.
Yeah. Oh my god.
A rock.
Bigger hallway. Jesus Christ, yes. I feel fat.
I still want to talk to you when we get a minute. We'll go take a ride.
Oh wait, okay. Let me show you guys. I think this is outside of prison.
This is crazy.
Rockford!
Fuck! Rockford. Yeah. Dude, this guy is fucked.
Okay, can we open up?
Rockford, this is the kitchen here. Entrance. Okay.
Yeah, I think this is the outside. What is... Oh, it's come cool. On, show me the key. Where is the damn key? I think this got to open from the control room.
What frequency are you guys going to be on?
What?
Hello? Somebody!
Rockford, can you come to the front? 130.
I think...
Rockford, so what's the protocol now when I bring somebody here?
I bring them here.
Okay, so I think this is going to be open from the,
Yeah, what's going to happen?
From the... I think it's going to be open from the control room. Because the control room has so many buttons right now.
That's really cramped.
Hey, Jake.
Hey,
Jake. I'm gonna, if anyone asks, I'm gonna dream about my dog. I'll be right back.
Right, it's this door here. Is that not the door there?
You need to go back. What's wrong?
What up, gang?
Oh. Gonna park this car real quick.
Yeah, so I'm thinking that...
Okay, one moment. I can deal with Zen, okay?
I don't have the time to actually show you guys, but I think that's the whole prison right now. Let's see.
I'm gonna stay here for a while.
Hello?
Alright,
what's up?
So...
Are you going back to
the... I'm gonna speak to the people
people nope.
that set up the checkpoint, and I'm gonna get that changed up.
I believe that on another Mary note, 161 is it possible is for me to visit my sons and tell them to stop giving you a hard time? Not a problem.
Alright, so let's just have a walk around the building. Let's show you guys a little bit about, you know, this is the courtyard. So this is where everything's gonna take place, like from the playing, the basketball, the weightlifting, you know, gym. It's pretty much gonna be happening here. Yeah, this is actually gonna be fun. I can't wait to see what the warden actually have for it, you know.
Oh, dude.
I can't wait to actually see what the warden actually, what kind of plan the warden has for it.
Standing by.
Can we get the garage door open in the back of the DOC?
Dude, this guy's straight shitting water.
Alright guys, welcome.
They've got a fire department in to sort him out.
Jake,
Sam, 1161.
Yeah, what's that door code right there?
This one?
Yeah.
This is hallway 2.
Oh, hallway 2?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. How about this one? Okay, this is the kitchen, right?
This is kitchen.
Wow.
That one over there is, yeah.
Mary 161, when you can, Sam 21 needs a psyche bow, wasn't
pretty
an option
sure
while shooting.
This, one, so. This is observation, though, if it would be called a room.
10-5.
Oh, okay. Observation. How about the hallway right there? Yeah. Is that a hallway?
Down there?
Yeah.
That is either hallway 1 or most people call it yard. Door to the yard.
Oh, I see.
So call it yard. D,
could
I get a ride
along? Amazing. Wow. So when we bring a prisoners to the prison, we just mainly hand over
it's
to the OC, right?
You're supposed to, but right now I think you're booking them in because there's no really DOC on that. None of us got white papered yet, so.
Oh, I see.
So we can't do anything. So practically, you're putting them in the small jail. They do the same thing here. It will just be in this issue until we get white papered. Then you'll hand them over to us.
Oh, I see. All right, cool. Alright, so you guys heard it. When we bring the criminals and the suspects to the prison, we don't hand over, we don't give them to DOC. Pretty much process them by ourselves till the DOC is functional. Alright, so you guys are going to get your last gaze on the prison and take a picture of that. And yeah, let's get on our way, let's get on patrol.
You got uniforms?
Alright.
Close garage door. We need uniforms, people.
Alright, let's get back on patrol, guys. Let's get back on patrol. Oh, just want to switch to my taser real quick.
Do you need EMS down there? What is going on?
Alright, there we go. Reload that taser.
Host
the taser, and let's get back on patrol.
I need two people to do this, Sam. Right. I need one person
so,
to do the,
you guys are in the prison.
Panel. I'm one person. Yeah.
There we go. Sam 22 will be back tonight. Alright guys, let's get back in patrol and see who we're gonna catch today.
Yes. Yeah.
Cause we have a lot of guys to catch. But yeah, the prison is amazing. I mean, what do you guys think? You know, let me know in the description what you guys think about a prison. You know, yeah, they have to take this down. This is some bullshit.
Did anyone hotel to any members of DOC?
Yeah, this is some bullshit. They need to take that down. But yeah, you know, it's looking good. They put it in on the right place on the island. You know, close to water, so you can pretty much escape. You can't do anything. Did I just? Oh yeah, my wood is out. Sorry about that, guys. Let me just fix that, and we could be on our way. You know, they pretty much just put it in the best place on the island where it's gonna be hard for someone to escape, because we're gonna have DOC tracking you down. I said DOC, we're gonna have
Lincolnton, attention all units, all cadets report to the prison.
as soon as possible for DOC training.
So we're gonna have
David 31 Hotel to Link 11.
You know, pretty much gonna have. Oh, go to the control room upstairs. I just did, William.
Are you looking for Lincoln 10?
You know, it's a really
yeah,
small room
sorry.
Where you know they control
yeah,
the where they pretty much control the whole rooms and everything, and the doors
negative
on the hallway
time
and everything
being
like that.
All inmates at the sheriff's department until DOC is completely trained.
Ah, come on. What the hell is going on? Oh, we gotta go this way.
This is Cadet 242. If I can't get a ride, could I take my personal vehicle to the prison?
That's some glitch. Alright. Yeah, we're free. What? Alright, there we go. So like I told you guys, DOC is not going to be functional for like another 2 to 3 days, because the warden have to figure out who he's going to be placing in what position, because he's just getting, you know, used to it right now and used to the prison. And yeah. For those of you joining my stream, this is ATPL, which is Amateur Project Life. Welcome to the Godfather stream. You know, welcome to the biggest bosses stream, and you bosses too get to watch me. What is he doing? We're pulling him over, and he knows he's getting pulled over right now. Oh, you know you're getting pulled over, darling. You know you're getting pulled over, darling. And you know you're getting pulled over. Sam 22, 1038, on a semi-truck. Westbound towards Main Town, close to the prison. Yeah, so...
Paul.
Let's go talk to him, see why he was swerving off the road like that. You know, he could kill me. Could actually kill someone. You know, so really bad. Alright. Let's have a chat with him. Hello, sir. How you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good, man. What about you?
Good. Sergeant Leahy with the sheriff's office. You know the reason why I pulled you over, obviously.
I have no idea. I mean, I assume you're speeding, but I
on code three deliveries.
You were not speeding, but I saw you.
The SD right now.
You couldn't maintain your lane right back there. You were actually head on with me. You almost hit me back there.
There's a icy blue
so,
crown for
I guess you were. It was hard to actually control the truck. So, I don't know if you noticed, but when you're driving these trucks, you have to slow down because they tend to swerve real fast. All right, can you step out of the truck with your driver's license, proof of insurance, and registration for me? Thank you, Mr. Alex. Hold on.
Yeah, Paul 69's got them in visual. I'm coming up to them.
10-4.
Alright. Thank you. Step back into your vehicle. I'll be right back with you, okay?
Yeah, sure.
They're past him, coming towards the clinic area.
Alright, guys. We're just going to run his name. See what he comes back to. You know, if he comes back clean, if he comes back with a warrant. We could pretty much know what we could issue him with. We could let him go if his record comes back clean. I'm just gonna look for his complete name because I didn't get his name. Yeah, someone said Alex Murray. Got it.
161 Sam 21.
Alex.
Sam 21 Sam. Okay, we're heading up to Stony Creek, past the bowling alley.
Alright, so we got that name now. We're just gonna run his name
control
on the database.
Okay, break. I'm gonna need the backup. They're heading up to Stony Creek.
When you're ready, meet me at the clinic on prison grounds.
Look up. Alex.
10-4.
Mosey. Alright, he comes back with a warning. Let's see what the warning was for.
Lincolnton, do I have all cadets heading to the prison as right now?
Cadet 242 en route to the prison.
Still doing a pickup at the
SO. One enlist for Alex.
Do I have a unit that can pick up cadets at the SO and bring them to the prison?
Mosey.
David 31 needs to wait for an order from Code 3 Industries before I can move him over.
I see Wake going back to...
In about 10 minutes I can do that.
Entry by William Jones, I don't know what this is, there was no description or anything, but, okay. You know what, we're just gonna give him a warning again, it's that warning.
Paul 69 at the
Alex.
Fire Department training ground, I've loved a visual of the armed suspects with a hostage.
Could you just block off the entrance and then I can be there sometime soon, hopefully?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to check the firing ground. They added that or they went to steel mill. I have no idea.
10-4.
Alright. So let's go talk to him. We've given him a warning right now, so he's got to be careful from now on not to get a ticket from us. Yeah. Alright, partner, here's your driver's license, registration, and proof of insurance back. I'm just going to issue you a warning right now, so next time just make sure... Yeah, fine. That's cool. Next time just make sure that you're slowing down for me, okay?
Yeah, and, it's like driving through treacle with this thing, man.
I know. It's pretty heavy and it's hard to control, but you know that's why you have to be slow, especially when you come to bands like that, you know. You have to just, you know, be slow, so you could be able to maintain your lanes,
alright?
Yeah, alright, good. Be safe, alright? Drive safe for me.
Steel factory.
You too, man.
I believe I might have visual on the Crown Vic. Negative, it's a Ford.
David 31 to anyone near Steel, over. Like Warren Steel.
Okay, okie dokie. Let's see.
Paul 69, they are at Steel Mill. Need an additional here.
Alright. Turn that back off. And we're good to go. Okay. Back up patrol.
Repairing his vehicle, white pants, brown shirt.
Cut at 242, 1020 at the prison.
Hi everyone that's joining right now. Thank you for joining up with the Godfather, the biggest boss's channel. Yeah, I can see you guys are actually enjoying the stream. Thank you guys for joining me. Hope you guys are loving it. And I can see someone is actually loving the system. He says, holy shit, the system is awesome. Yes, it is. That's why I'm playing here. You know what I mean? That's why I'm here. System is amazing. You know, it's like real life. They're trying to make it as real life as possible. And, you know, this is as realistic as it gets.
David 31 is heading up to prison in 1 meg, and then he'll be down to Steel Mill.
10-4, I've got the entrance blocked, waiting.
Something which is going to be 76 to Steel Mill.
Okay, be advised, he's got his vehicle facing the exit, so he's probably going to get ready to run when we pull in.
Alright guys, let's go help some people out. They need our help for the Steel Mill right now. Yep, let's go see. Where's the steel mill at again? Yeah, it's close to farms. I think we're going to take the next exit.
Could I take 31 plus 2, 1076 to the prison?
Mm.
This is Cadet 226, I'm now 10-8 at SD.
Whoa, what the hell? What the? Oh no, this ain't happening right now. Why do they got lamps on the roadway? What the hell is going on? Why they got lamps on the driveway though? What the hell?
242 waiting in the lobby at the prison for the training.
Where are we right now? We're actually going, okay. Yeah, I think we're at the steamer right now, right? Yeah, we gotta turn around, man. Cool. Yeah, why the hell did they have lamppost on the driveway? What the... What? Come on, that's under the fire station, guys. Under the fire station. What the hell is actually going on? What kind of EP was that? Some 22B, 1076, 1023 on steel mail. Alright, so we're trying to apprehend the suspect that we're actually waiting for right now.
Yeah, again!
It's the car, it's the cars, yeah. Sir, they just drove away. They just drove away, idiots!
It's a purple, I think it's a purple Crown Vic. Where did he go? I think he went this way or went back to Stony Creek. I can't even find it again.
SD, please be advised that fire department is conducting
I think we lost eyes on it.
Exercise.
It went back to Stony Creek.
Lubbock and fire department training yard.
I think we lost eyes on it. Yeah, I think we lost eyes on that Crown Vic because the deputy, I don't know what he was doing. Yeah.
David 31, I got two more cadets over at prison for training.
But yeah, we're just going to be looking out for that Crown Vic. Hopefully, we'll find it. I think he went back to Stony Creek. That's my idea, and that's what happened because it's going to take him a while to get to the highway. He either went back to Stony Creek, because that was fast. He went back to Stony Creek, or he went back to the main town, which is that way. So let's go look around and see if we can find someone that matches that description. What rank...
They may have doubled back, I'm not sure.
Do you have to be to use a towel? You have to be a sergeant rank. Williams to use the towel.
Be advised, David 31 Hotel is 10-7 at the prison for a Code 3 order.
All units on patrol, be advised, Bolo on a teal Crown Vic, possibly armed, hostage in the car as well.
Jesus. Oh, so that was a hostage situation. Alright. Yeah. Okay. I got you guys. I got you. I'm trying to see to head back to sheriff's office to see if there's any cadets that would like to do DOC training right now because they're trying to do it. I might just go over there just to have you guys have eyes on the training and see how we train the cadets.
On the side business,
Is that a cadet?
Yes, sir.
Is there any more cadets in here?
Not that I'm aware of.
You two, are you a cadet? Alright, if you're cadets, hop into my Tahoe. There's a DOC training that's about to go down right now. So, hop in. Who's that? Alright, we'll be going back to the prison and, have you guys do your DC training, okay?
Alright. Apparently it's mandatory, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Day 6, is it?
Huh?
Day 6 or whatever, or is it just a separate bit?
Yes, day 6.
Oh, I still need day 3.
You being Jimmy?
Yes.
Long time no see.
This out anyway.
Good. You know, I've been training with you guys and working and also, you know, getting tired. But yeah, I've been good.
That's nice to be back in the department again.
Yeah.
In Japan.
Yeah, you know, this time, they're trying to make it more fun than Alpha.
Well, yeah.
Alpha wasn't too bad.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad for me.
A bit bad at the end, but... I think when me and Vianetta were in charge, it was...
Sam 22 plus 2 kid at en route to prison for DOC train.
Oh, I guess I get to get day 6 knocked out of the way, even though I still need, like, day 3, 4, and 5.
Yeah, today's day 3 training. We're going to be doing day 3 training by 9 p.m. Eastern time, so...
I won't be around. No one was on for the AU time.
Oh, okay, cool.
They might do day 3 and 4 tomorrow or something, I don't know.
Yeah, tomorrow's day 4, so, yeah.
Might see if they can do day 3 for missing.
At least not on time, anyway.
Yes, I might.
Might have to schedule.
Yeah, I can do it for you, I guess.
Day 4 training differently.
Paul 71, Sprit switching over to, prison frequency.
DLC doesn't take too long, though. I might try to get day 4 today, and then do day 3 later on.
I'm just trying to say, why the hell do they have,
Definitely won't be able to do it tomorrow.
Why the hell do they have deputies actually trying to do the DOC training? The deputies have to be patrolling. They have people over there that can do the DOC training by themselves. But well.
They moved it. It's no longer on an island. Let's see. Oh.
That driving was 10 over 10, right? I know. Hey guys, welcome to my... live stream, guys. Welcome to my live stream. Thank you for your support. Thank you for all your wishes, and you know, hopefully you guys enjoy the live stream. So we're currently just dropping these guys off for the DOC training. Pretty much got to open the door for them either way. All right, let's step out, guys. We're here.
Shiren's a broken man.
Cadets, call me. This is gonna be a shit.
Broken man.
130.
What?
Irons, they're broken.
No, they're not. Yeah, just, you have to go back to sleep and wake back up. I don't know.
Yes.
You will.
God, they're gonna follow me in here.
Okay, see, William said they should make it to where you have a prison van to transport criminals. Yes, we do have a prison van, but it's in the works right now, so... You know, for now it's not out yet, but when it comes out, you're definitely going to be seeing it around the island. Yeah.
Sam 21, no time was issued, and I'm back at SD due to major confusion.
Paul 69, show me 10-8 district.
My name's Ethan Barker. I was looking for the tour.
Guys, keep going.
Yeah,
let's go.
School on 3. All the cadets go through that door.
Every single
get through
one.
That door. Get through. Go through the door.
Yo, Ronford, I just came back, and I wanted to let you know that I did not get Mirandized either. I also have that on GoPro when they seized it.
Oh, fuck. This is going to be a disaster.
Find out, because I still want to be in prison.
Keep moving.
You guys have to keep moving. Close. Keep moving to the hallway. Keep going. Jesus. Keep moving to the hallway, guys. Let's go. Jesus. Guys are just blocking the whole place.
Don't yell.
And can I come back and then make up the time?
I'm not used to these sudden shifts of location.
I just don't. gotta get up to the control room, because that guy can do this for me.
The yard, and just line up along the back wall, please.
Alright guys, I'm gonna switch to the DOC frequency, which is, I think it's 103. Hold on guys. Ready to check?
1, 2, 3, 4, opening.
Just line up down here, line up the back.
I got him.
Yeah, that is nice.
Okay, so the door doesn't want to close, that's fine. Wait, I think I missed the frequency, I think it's 102. 102.
All those beautiful cops over there.
Wait, to check.
Actual people.
You on the right channel, Jim? 130?
Oh, it's 130, oh, now I see.
Yeah, what's going on? Matt Evans, buddy.
130.
Well, let me do this first. Holy shit, you have to show me that.
Wait, to check, Brady.
Andrew.
Yeah, now nah, guys, we're on the right channel
show
now.
Show me the hall door open.
Ah, no, sir.
Alright, close 1, 2, 3, and 4, please.
Closing 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Amazing, I'm just gonna get into the observation room. Let's see how this place looks. Woo! I'm freaking out right now, guys. Yay, look at this. Observation room. It's the glass is tinted, so there's no way you could. Ooh, is that weed?
Back in my head.
Yep.
What the fuck is that? That's weed, right? What the hell is that? That looks like weed. What?
Dug it mild clothes back, yeah.
Oh yeah, that's weed. I was like, what? Yeah, that's weed. What the hell is weed doing in prison, yo? People are actually trying to troll us right now. Swear to God. Alright, I'm just gonna drop it. There we go. Okay, so this is the observation room. The glass is tinted, so this is where deputies actually stand and keep watch over the prisoners and what they do when they open up the prison cells. So if anyone is fighting, they're gonna first get observed by the deputies or the DOC officers in this room. Yeah, right? Xavier, I was like, what is weed doing on the floor? That's weed. It looked like weed. I was like, what the hell? Look at that. That's marijuana right there.
Yeah, 10 out of 10.
But that shit look real. But that's some weird looking pack of marijuana. There you go.
Overlord.
Vacation season is good for watching your stream. I know, right? I know, Xavier. It's actually when I always stream because school resumes next week for me, next week Monday, so you'll be getting like, you know, a little bit of some live stream for me. Mainly you'll be getting like videos for me, then live stream because I'll be busy to do a live stream, so. Why is there an observation room? There's a control tower. Williams, good question. The control towers are actually located outside of the DOC. So we this room and the second floor right there, as you can see, is needed because we're gonna have so many DOC offices everywhere. So you're gonna have some of them in here, and like I said before, this room, the glass is tinted, right, so. When you go from outside, you can't see who's inside. So when you go from outside, let me just show you right now. When you go from outside, you can't actually see who's inside. So it's difficult for you to know that there's someone in there. So if you mess up and there's a DOC officer in there, you're in trouble. So I'm just gonna show you how it looks. You see from outside, it's tinted. See? You can't see anyone in there, right? So obviously they can only see you from inside. See what?
It was fucking aiming the taser at me like it was shoving my
arms. Look in the room.
Yeah, this. Yeah, I actually saw it.
No, that was me. That was all my other three.
I was like, what the hell? I was like, what the hell is weed doing on the floor?
I see, but we have nowhere to put it. We don't have anywhere to put it. So,
you need to.
Sergeant, come here.
Sir. guys. Business.
Sergeant. Sergeant, I'll pay you back. I want you to take these guys to the Lubbock, and I want you to give them $250 each, and I'll pay you back. All right? Because we took their clothes.
Yes, sir. Definitely. All right, guys. Come with me, guys.
Let's go out the back of the garage.
Sergeant, can I get your name?
All right. Just make sure Ronin overload fails.
Garage door, please.
Can I join the party over there, boys?
Oh, Jake's back.
Jake's back, dude. Leaving Jake.
Yeah, can I come?
All right, guys, come with me, guys. Come with me, guys. Let's go.
Can Jake come, lads?
Hold a sec. I think another guy's coming.
Come with me, guys. Let's go. All right, we're gonna be heading to the parking lot right now, so I can get you guys back to the Lubbock, right?
All right.
Cheers.
Oh, you went out of his head.
So yeah, William, so hopefully I answered your question. So the reason why we have the observation room in there is for us to be able to catch deputies, for us to be able to catch criminals do crime or commit crime in prison way easy than if we have a control tower. That's why we don't have a control tower outside, because there's no need for it. Because the prison is a no-go area, so it's heavily guarded.
Banana hammocks on the floor.
So happy the prison is done. Yes! Estona, I'm happy too that the prison is done, if I'm saying your name right. I hope I'm saying your name right. Yeah, hold on, let me just turn on my lights right now. Shit is not even funny right now. Hold on. Alright, is everyone in here?
Yep. I think Jake's coming, is he not?
Yeah,
I think Jake is coming.
I thought there were three people.
Yeah.
Fuck those, dude, where he is.
Yo, ask Rockford if Jake's allowed to come with us. He's back in his head.
Yeah, but I think he had like 300 mobs, did he?
Well, that he's getting out because we were too.
Sam 22 to Warden Rocksdale. Do we? I still have one more guy missing. Is he still in the prison?
Boys, can't just get out here. I'll snap it.
Dude, America.
Okay. 10-4. Alright, guys. We're gonna be going without Mr. Jake.
Oh, let's just bowl it. Double time, let's go. Cope it silent.
Whoa, what the fuck?
Max speed it, fuck it.
What the fuck?
Dude, we ain't going anywhere now.
Yes, we are. Just give me a few minutes, alright?
Can I sleep here on the grass?
Nah, just stay in the vehicle. You'll be good.
Garage door, please. Garage door.
See, William said, I can't wait until there's a riot. Oh, there's been so many riots, dude. There have been so many riots on this island. You can't even imagine. There have been a lot. I've been involved in a lot of riots. Mainly involving tasing, you know. That's the main thing that always happens. But we don't have tear gas in here, but I wish we did, you know. Hop in! Ah, come on. Let's go.
Dude, did I get stuck? Fuck.
Garage door.
One sec.
The garage door, please.
You got stuck again?
Officer, can I
no,
sleep
like,
on the
it says I'm in. I'll be right back.
Oh, there you go.
Can I just sleep on the grass?
No, you're going with me to Lubbock to get your money. Do you want your money or not?
I don't give you seven shades of shit about $250. Can I sleep in, please?
No, you can. You're coming with me outside, buddy.
That's Oscar Rogaine. He's bringing it, uniforms inside.
Oh, let's bounce.
10-4.
Alright, what's the other dude? Okay, I'm just waiting on the other person and we could be going.
Why are you doing co-driver? You fucking turned really slowly.
Yeah, that's because I was talking on my radio. Let me see. Where did he go?
Like, why is my head turning really slowly in co-driver?
I don't know.
Bitch.
Oh, there you are, hop in! Let's go. Let's go, let's go.
Oh man, I need to go to sleep in my head. We'll get up early.
Let's go, buddy, let's go.
Not my fault it broke.
I know. Hopefully there'll be a... What did he say? Hopefully there'll be a jailbreak every time. Jailbreaks would not be a thing over here because, you know, in real life they don't really happen. You know, it's... For me, jailbreak only happen in movies. So, they wouldn't be a thing. Like, jailbreaks wouldn't be a thing over here, so... If you jailbreak someone, you could get permanently banned. Something like that. I hope it doesn't get, you know, it doesn't become a thing because it's just going to be so boring. Yeah, because jailbreaks are like, you know, things that always happen in movies, you know, they don't happen in real life. It's rare to see, like, a jailbreak in real life. I've never, you know, turned on my TV or the news and you know, hear that, you know, someone got jailbreaked from a prison in the U.S. That's like suicide. What are you bringing them? I'm taking them back to Lubbock. I'm just going to give them some money and then take it the other way. Whoa, missed that. Almost missed it. Yeah. My driving sucks right now, for real.
10-4, you copy.
Hey. So hope you guys are enjoying the live stream. And I just want to say thank you to my new subscribers that are subscribed to my channel. It's amazing having you guys on my channel watching my videos. Welcome to the Godfather's Nation. You know, the biggest... Oh, what the hell? Oh, look. You see,
how did we not just die?
I know, right? Oh, the best driver, man. Telling you, the best driver in Fisher's Island right there. Oh,
that pink car.
Move.
Fucking taxis did this shit.
I know, right? He's been waiting there forever. Like,
open cell too.
Wait, didn't the taxis have a top thing?
Last time I checked,
they
did.
I think you can add it at that garage.
Oh. Yeah, as I was saying before I got interrupted by these two clowns over here. Yeah, for my new subscribers, welcome to the Godfather's channel, you know, the biggest boss's channel. And, you know, you guys should expect more from me. You know I haven't been making videos or live streaming, but I'm going to make it up to you guys. You know, I have plans for this channel, like I told you guys before. I'm planning to get myself a new beast gaming computer coming up soon. The new Asus G051 is coming on. It's coming to this channel, and I'm going to show you guys everything from the unboxing and everything that I have. I'm also going to be getting a new monitor from Amazon. It's going to be a 4K monitor, so I want to change my whole gaming experience in this channel. So my graphics is all going to be new, and everything's going to be shiny and looking good for you guys, and looking kind of HD-like. So hopefully you guys can stay tuned and watch out for that change on my channel.
Cell to open, please. Cell to open.
Yeah, so we're currently going to the bank right now. I'm just giving them some money and they could be in the way. What is he doing? What are you doing? Nah, now you see me and you don't want to do what you wanted to do. See that? Eye service right there. Eye service right there, guys. We're here, guys. Alright, hop out.
You're gonna say you're gonna like kill us back here?
Let me get in.
Alright guys, I'll be right back. Just give them some money.
You want me to take it to the
car? Hello, I'm busy. So you know how low give them some money and it can be in the way. Ramps on the truck. So you 250, he wanted me to give him 250. We're going from, we could go from here.
I want to maybe do some towing service.
We're going from behind the bank right now, guys. Low boy.
So if they're broken out tires, I can just take them back to the shop.
250, that's like 500.
Boys, I gotta go night-nights in a bit, alright? Thanks for the lift, officer. It was nice here.
Oh, it is. Damn.
Alright, there you go. Who's the first person I'm giving this money to?
Mm-hmm.
We'll just make sure they have two tires first.
Alright, there we go.
The money did.
As long as they have the front or the back, just have
to thank you.
Oh, where did he go? He left?
Yeah, he went to sleep.
Oh, okay. Alright, fantastic. Alright, see you later, bro.
Yeah.
You might want to close the garage. Guys, close.
No, I didn't know you have to be...
Okay, so we're gonna go back to DLC and let's get this going.
And it worked fine. Oh, okay.
Well, that's really good. Great prison, great prisoners at the bank, legally.
So what's the trick with the ramps?
Yeah, I know. It's frustrating sometimes. So we'll be heading back to the prison, you know, have you guys see a little bit of the prison before we, before I end the stream. But yeah, so like I told you guys, expect a lot from this channel, expect a lot from me. And you know, we're gonna make this channel dope, guys. We're gonna make it dope, you know. Man, I was just surprised the way my channel grew so fast. Like, I was like, what? I opened my YouTube channel and I was like 150 subscribers. I was hoping, I was begging to get to 100 before Christmas of last year. And I was surprised to see 150, guys. I was like, whoa, how many airports are on the island? I think we have one. Let me just show you the map real quick. I think we have one airport on the island. I think they're willing to expand. So that's the airport right there. This is the airport right here. This airport is home to the Coast Guard. So this is where Coast Guard get their planes from, the Jayhawk, the boats and everything. I think so. Yeah. So this is, we have only one airport. I think they're gonna expand it pretty soon. I don't know if they wanna have two airports, but I don't know where the second one's gonna be at. But I think Fiji's Island have just one airport, which has the ability for incoming and outgoing flights. So this is going and this is coming in. But yeah. What kind of sound was that? Oh, that's a BMW. It's like, what? Alright. So remember, if you have any questions, drop it on the chat below and I'm gonna answer your questions.
Open garage door.
Oh, what is he doing? He's speeding like real bad. And I think that guy's chasing after him. Oh, look at that tow truck driving without his lights. Look at him. You're so lucky right now that I'm actually heading to the prison. If not, I would put your ass over. He's so damn lucky right now that I'm actually heading to the prison. I would have put his ass over. Like, they're one of the guys that should know the rules of driving with your lights when it's nighttime. But you know, they tend to just ignore it and be like, oh no, you know what? I'm a government worker, so I can just drive without my lights on. And yeah, they just get pulled over and a heavy ticket for doing that. You know, that's some cheese. Is that new Camaro Fast? I think it is. Yes, it is. How many beds are in the prison? I'm gonna show you right now. You know, you're gonna obviously have the eyes to count it and see it. Well, I'm just gonna count it with you. I think they have two bunks, if I would put it that way. You know, two bunks. One person gotta stay under, and one person gotta stay upstairs. I'm just gonna wait for that dude. If he can drive. Oh, he can drive. Amazing. you know, let's just do this 10 over 10 right here. You know, we went to training and shit. Oh, we just failed. Oh, look at that fail. Oh, I can't drive. Look at this. Are you not thirsty? What do you mean by thirsty? Like thirsty for the Camaro?
Originally needs to be opened again.
Xavier, what are you talking about? Are you talking about like thirsty for the Camaro or thirsty for the for water? Okay, I enjoy prison tours. Oh yeah, me too. That's why I'm getting back here. Hey, show you guys a little bit about a prison. Let's go, let's go. Hype. Yeah, I think the prison just came out today. I think it came out. Oh, look at that. Oh, I'm thirsty right now. Oh, look at that Camaro. Look at that beast. Oh, what? I'm gonna probably get this. Oh, yes. Damn, wait, let me let him start the car. Hello, sir. Hello. Yeah, I think he's actually dreaming. Oh, what? Whoa, what? Just, what happened? Where did he go? What the hell? What? Okay, I'm done.
You wanna jump on that?
No way.
The jail.
Okay. Look at this cheese.
Okay, so anything over an hour, they're gonna come over here. So what we're gonna do is this is how it's working right now. You guys make the arrest. You put them into the cells over there, and DOC will come and pick them up. And when they're done over here, their time is done.
Do you know where they are?
They'll be out
you at all.
In town.
Do you know
themselves.
Where they're doing the training? Is it
back in
the
men
training?
Cadet training upstairs, if that's what you asked. It's a little hard to hear over us.
I know.
Two. Maximum two. So, close cell 3 here, Clyde.
Oh, it's closed.
No, I don't think there's a max. Sir, I think there's, for the prison, I think it's, I'm going to look at the 260 or 360.
Oh, let's go. We miss a lot, guys. We missed a lot of training. Let's go. I'm hiring this shit up right now.
Oscar's open.
Close it.
You see anybody over there, Clyde?
Open garage? It. Open.
Oh, yeah. It's over
here. Someone's unloading something.
Can I get cell 3, please?
Open hallway 1.
Cell 3 is closed, sir.
Or 2.
Cell 3 is closed.
I don't even know.
Cell 3 is not closed.
Is that hallway 1 or 2?
Cell 3 is closed.
Open 3 and close it again, Clyde. Watch out.
It's opening.
Yeah.
See it?
I'm going to be honest, this outside walls don't look that maximum security. Oh yes, they don't. But, you know, there's just going to be a rule that says, you know, no one can actually jailbreak. So, pretty much. Open hallway 2.
Yeah, Oscar's over there. Anybody
white,
let's stay here.
Come on, man.
Sarge, you going to stay here? Sarge?
Open hallway 2. Ah, really, my nigga? Open the hallway too! Jesus!
Open the hallway, man, guys.
Thank you! What? I just said that shit over the radio. Open hallway too! My god.
Hallway? Alright. Opening hallway.
So what frequency are you on up there?
Jesus, I know, right? It's 130.
SD plus 70.
Whoa, look at this cheese. They changed the frequency again. What? Oh, wait, no. They didn't. It's correct.
You need to open the hallway.
Open cell 4.
I'm trying to. My character is moving way back and forth like he's drunk. Stand by.
Wait, he said SD plus what? Oh, plus 70. Oh.
Are you through the hallway?
Thank you. Jesus.
Got it?
Open cell 5.
Alright, guys. Yeah. So, we're wondering how many beds. The person who asked that question, how many beds are in the prison. There you go. There's one. For one person only. We just want to do one suspect in one cell. But when it gets crowded, we just put them together. So, they get to sleep. Together, I guess. you know, I don't really care, because if you commit a crime, that's up to you. So if the prison doesn't have space for you, they, you know, pretty much pack you up with someone else. So, I don't really care. So, you know, if you commit a crime, this is what you see. Oh, let me show you guys our new inmates. This is our new inmate trainer, guys.
Have two guards escort him. He's a wild one.
Listen, guys. The way it works is...
Definitely not green material, if
depending,
you know I mean.
Depending on your crime or the charges you went to jail for, they have different uniforms. So this guy's a green, which they are mostly...
Don't run, Robbie.
Misdemeanor guys. So, misdemeanor guys get the green, so they're non-violent. See that? They're non-violent, and they get the green.
I'm grabbing your tie, and I just kissed you on the cheek.
See?
No, you want to kiss me on the lips, Justin?
See, they
grab his tie.
They get the they get a non-violent uniform.
Right. Keen, can you give them
the car?
Yeah, Keen, can you go over the basic?
Where are they at?
The basic.
Yeah, press your eye muscle.
Oh, okay. They're upstairs right now.
You want to take them all out to the yard and go over the basic stuff.
So pretty much like I told you guys before, if you were following me on my channel, they pretty much deliver food to the prison. So this is what, so this is how they do it. They deliver food, and food can be given to the inmates so they can eat. And those are uniforms right now for the inmates. So the inmates can grab their uniforms and head back
cell five.
To the, you know, back to the cell. So we have cell 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You have 14 cells in prison right now, so not to mention we have detainment room,
the garage door open.
Or as you can call it, the interrogation room.
Right.
Wow, it looks amazing. What do you guys think? It looks amazing, guys. I love it.
DLC, go ahead.
I'm gonna see if I can stand over here.
Yes, this is ex Coast Guard pilot Ryan Kowalski.
Mr. Inmate. Copy that, Mr.
can I get an ET?
Stand by, yes.
Can I get an ET on when we can go out in the yard, please? Over.
Yes, you can go to the yard, yes.
I'll be right back, guys. Okay. Just give me 5 minutes, yes. 5 minutes. Yeah, enjoy the view. Please. 5 minutes.
Copy that, all right.
Ranger, back up.
Copy that.
So Matt can back up.
This is nice, I like this, you know?
I was trying to, it was just a clusterfuck at the moment.
Why are you guys back over here? Why are you back over here? What the fuck? What are you doing here still, man? Oh my gosh. You two went out of your heads when I was getting you guys transported back, man.
Could I have hallway opened up, please, control room?
You want to stay? Okay, alright, that's fine then.
Flabbergasted.
Open it up, McLaurin. We don't have enough room.
So,
let's just go.
Oh, guys, I'm back.
You guys don't think it's safe for you outside.
Okay.
There they come. Those are the cadets in training, guys. Cadets in training.
This is Ocean 16 requesting a hallway opened up from control room, over.
Alright, okay.
Open the hallway! Jesus.
Okay, stand by.
Oh wait, is Rockstar...
Damn, don't get your panties in a bunch.
Wait, is Rocksteel actually the one doing the
Undersheriff is in the control room.
Really? Why?
You were yelling at the Undersheriff.
I don't know, I thought it was someone else there. But what? Well, why the hell is he doing the the control room? Is someone else gotta
Sergeant,
do it?
Mind if I grab your name tag?
No.
Alright guys, Lieutenant's this way.
Osama Walker.
Oh yeah.
Lady,
right?
Ocean 16 to
yes,
room,
that's me. You know,
hey,
yeah,
lady.
You know my voice now. Good.
Yeah, dude.
It's Jimmy Leahy, right?
Yes, sir.
Right now.
You got it.
Likes being called Big Jim.
Yes, please. If you want to call me that, that's amazing. Yeah.
I'm not gonna tell you. I'm not gonna tell you it's Jim old Leahy.
No, please don't. Yeah, Big Jim is gonna work. Yeah, biggest boss. Big Jim right there, guys. Oh yeah, we're going to the yard, guys. Going to the yard.
No,
yay!
No, I'm over on the other end. I know.
Come on.
Dude, if I find another...
Someone, look at this!
Control room, yard door can be closed.
Someone, look at this! Oh, yes, sir! Nice. Now we're outside the yard, right now we can go to gym!
Thank you, Control.
Someone hit someone upside the head with one.
It's gonna be awesome.
Could be a problem.
Chain them down. Where's the weight at?
I'm trying to go to the gym.
Wait, hold on. Let me do this right now. There we go. Oh, I can't find a weight. Fuck.
My brain's dressing so I can toss the salad.
Well, I guess I can start.
It's all floating.
Let everyone go in the lineup.
Hey, say again the traffic for control.
I just need the yard door open again. I think the second door is linked to the button up there, control.
Oh, that's the weight. Yeah, let's lift that weight up.
Uh-oh, this might be a problem.
I'm through control. You're cleared to close the door again. Thank you.
Okay.
Move it!
Okay, let's have everyone.
You can't really
up.
Move very fast if you go backwards.
I have a question before you start. Okay. So what's to stop a civilian from coming up to the... Never mind. I got it.
What the hell was that? Jailbreak or something?
Okay, well then, that's fine.
What?
So, I really hope that y'all...
It'll stop.
Fucking do it, you won't.
Move it! Go!
Yeah, that door is linked. You got it at the door. You want to put your taser away. Put that thing away.
I'm going for the flashlight. I can't see.
It's daytime.
It's daytime.
Broad daylight.
What?
It's daytime, dude. It's fucking middle of the fucking
sorry,
night
guys.
For me. What the hell?
Give that guy some glasses.
You go to sleep and wake back up.
Give that guy some glasses. Give that guy some glasses.
Put that thing away.
Give that guy some glasses. You what?
It's fucking. I'm gonna take a fucking picture. Right now, dude.
He's a detective.
I'm done. He said it's night.
All right, I'll be
it's
back.
Dude, you need
bullshit.
Some glasses, bro.
Hey, dude. Now that I realize it's been dark
point.
For like the
we're
last 30
no.
minutes.
I'm done.
So obviously, we don't start up here when the inmates actually go and get transported. We obviously
that was so funny.
Learned that. They do get kept at the jail cell, but if you guys ever are a DOC assigned person, you're going to receive them from the front.
Outside of the cell.
So they should have already been searched upon you collecting them at the jail at SD, whether it be the north or south SD. But you're still going to search them upon them getting here. You're always going to search them. Every single time you move someone, you search them. You're going to search them. You're going to search the vehicle that they were transported with. You never know. Criminals have really sneaky ways of getting rid of things.
Criminals? Sorry.
Okay, yes. So, make sure you read all of the rules. Make sure you go over to follow the orders of the personnel. Everyone, just like it is for SD, you have a direct authority over everything. Well, you got a direct authority over everything here as well. Again, no fighting. What's going to happen if you fight? When they'll eat. When that actually is a thing, when we don't have iron stomachs, and also when visitation would be allowed. I'm not sure how visitation is going to be rolling, but if it's allowed, when that would be allowed and how that would go down. You would let them know that they should have already been searched, so all contraband should have been had, but if they did have it, you would take all their contraband. That would be basically everything. They don't get to keep anything. They could be like, all I was doing is I don't know, evading or something like that. If they make it to prison, they're not going to have a shovel. They're not going to have a pickaxe. They're not going to have their favorite teddy bear with them. They're going to have everything taken. There's no luxuries here. The only thing that they get to keep is the warden's clothes. That's the only thing they're going to be allowed to have.
Got a question.
So.
Jason, what happened?
Now I know.
Alright, now I'm hearing some loud siren.
Okay, McLean, stop. McLean, I'm talking. What's your question?
Okay, I know that inmates aren't allowed to have pretty much anything. But how is this going to work with there being cell phones? Are inmates allowed to have those?
They're not to have cell phones either. That's being taken as well.
Will those be confiscated upon patting them down? Or is that hasn't become an implemented thing yet? Okay.
Hey, Jimmy. Everything is being taken. You're not allowed cell phones
yes,
in this prison. You're not
do you hear a siren?
In this prison.
I have a
no. That might be some change to the warden, but as far as
so
I know,
so now it's day, but I hear
this
fucking siren.
Clothes.
Oh, wow.
They have those things on their back.
Don't fuck him out.
He had a hand up for us, yes.
William 1, can you open the hallway?
William, nothing is going on with the SD cells. They're all fine.
I think Miller hears it, too.
Close
I don't know if there's any event. I would say the only way that people are going to check out the prison is they're going to end up in the prison. If they want to find out, then by all means do something that makes yourself end up here, but I'm not encouraging that. But if you're a civilian, don't. It's almost all anywhere
right, close
past
yard
the
door.
Front areas, either staff or inmate areas.
Yard door
so
closed.
That's almost possible.
Alright, pop yard door one more time.
Again,
please.
The warden might want something different, but as that is, I mean,
yard door open.
In real prison, you don't get to walk through unless you're that troubled child that you see on YouTube that gets there scared straight
closed.
Or something like that. And that's just to scare the shit out of them. I mean, I'm not here to entertain trolls and be like, yeah, because some of them want to come here. They want to see what it's like. And, I mean, if they want to find out, they're going to do the time, and it's not going to be enjoyable here for them. I can promise you that.
King, what do we do? Do we give the stuff back at the end, or their belongings and stuff? Do we get it back, or does it just go? Like, say, if the tsunami came or something, and wiped the pools, what do we do?
Some of them
We don't have a way to store their stuff. We don't have a way to store their stuff right now, so I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know what to tell
them.
I asked Kane for something, for us as well, because we can't go off duty at the moment, I can't put my stuff away. So hopefully that gets done.
So you would hold your stuff in your vehicle, and then before you go to sleep, then you would put it back on. But per these criminals, just like the warden said, I mean, I guess it's just like, if you don't want to end up losing all your stuff because prison works the way it is, then you should not have done the time. If you don't like you lost your cell phone, well, you know what? I really don't care. You can go up to the goods factory and buy it for $300.
That's gone. That's dumb.
They did away with that. It's no longer auto impounded. Yeah.
Finally.
I saw on the chat box today, people were like bitching because they're like, tow truck drivers have nothing. I'm like, you know, that's the way it was for the last 8 months. You know, like for 3 days it was like auto impounding. You guys thought it was something else, but no, it's not. And so
there's not many abandoned cars about, you know. I didn't see any. I was going around today. People were asking me to mark them, and I looked and there was none there, so.
Yeah. Okay, Clyde?
At what point in the transportation of an inmate do you search them?
We should as an SD personnel on the SD side of the house, we should have searched them upon processing him. And I'm saying when they get here, they're gonna promise you the warden's gonna want them searched here too. They're gonna drop everything because they're gonna have to transfer clothes. They're gonna have to wear those prisoner clothes, so they're gonna end up having to get searched again. We're not gonna have no shanks or nothing like that get up in here. And yeah,
exactly.
Nothing like that. You can have guys like Jake Grayson or whatever calling like they've got human rights, they don't have to be searched, blah blah blah. They can be searched as many times as we want, as long as it isn't borderline harassment. Like it can't be like every 5 minutes you walk in there, okay, you're getting searched. But I mean, they're gonna get searched at processing. They're gonna get searched when we're here. The one wants it, like, hey, we'll do hourly searches on these guys to make sure they didn't get nothing in here. And also, that's legal rights. They don't have rights in prison. The only rights they have is food, going to the bathroom, and basic human dignity. That's about it.
Okay.
And medical.
Thank you.
All right.
And medical.
If I'm correct, Under Sheriff, when they are being searched, that's the point that they do drop their cell phone on the ground.
They're supposed to drop everything when they get here. And if you find them in their cell with stuff, seize it, and then let me know about it. Take note of it, who it was, and what they had with them, okay?
Right. Well, like the cell phone, you can't tell that they have a cell phone on them. They can just be like, oh, well, they can either choose to drop it or not. We can't tell that they actually have the cell phone on them.
Okay, but here's the thing. If they have a cell phone on them and they're using it to call their buddies to come over here, they're taking advantage of an exploit, okay? That's what they're doing. Because if I search you down to your underwear, there's only one place you can put something, which is your prison wallet, your ass crack, okay? That's the only place you could put something where if I strip you down to your underwear and a t-shirt, I should be able to see that stuff, right? So there's no way, unless you're keystring your cell phone, which, no, I don't believe that's happening, then they should give up everything, okay?
Alright, I have a question for this cadet over here, and I just need Rocksteer to actually answer it. When did they get to talk to the lawyers? Is it before you bring them to prison or at the SD?
This is how we're doing it. This is how it's going to have to work, okay?
I feel like when they get upstairs is harassing you right now.
When they get arrested and they're taken to the station, okay, you read them their Miranda rights when you arrest them. You take them to the station. You tell them their charges, and you tell them how they want to plead. If they plead guilty, you get it on GoPro, of course. You put them in the cell, you give them their time, and you're done. If they're going to do more than 60 minutes, they're going to come to the prison and do that, okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to take somebody into custody. You're going to do everything we've been doing with just the station jails. You're going to put them into the prison, the jail cells, and you're going to notify DOC that they have whatever number of people.
He is not going to be having any time.
Okay, copy that.
You went quiet, Warren. I think he's doing something in his head.
Alright. Do I understand that?
But I didn't hear you say anything.
You guys are not hearing me?
Yeah,
I hear you. You're
10-2.
Okay, alright. So you guys book them into the jail, put them in the cell, and notify DOC that you have one for pickup or two for pickup or whatever so we can bring enough vehicles to move them. If it happens to be a guy that's a high-risk inmate, like someone that's in a gang, notify Coast Guard and tell them you have one high priority to move, requesting an air unit to pick up at the Coast Guard air base and transport through the via air, helicopter to the prison, okay?
Would that be a two-man escort?
It's going to have to be a two-man escort because we have to have a vehicle. If you guys turn around and face that way, face the way I'm facing, you guys see the helipad?
Yep.
See the helipad? Okay. If you're here and you're going to assist with the guy moving into the cell, either a deputy needs to bring his patrol car over to pick the inmate up to move him to the back door of the prison, or we're going to walk him over there. But we need to do it very quickly. If we get like a Corman Shepherd or a Frank Boucher or a Jimmy Fung, we can expect someone to come along with a bunch of guns trying to break them out, correct?
Roger that.
Yeah. Right. So we have to have multiple plans that we can do, okay? Because if you look across the water there, you see the factory. It's a perfect point if they're watching what we're doing, okay? And they're telling their buddies what we're doing and how we're doing it. So we're watched at all times.
This is actually somewhat susceptible to a water attack if they can do it properly.
Can these fences be knocked down? That's my question.
I mean, you're right. If we're talking loud enough and they're at the water line right now, they can probably hear us, right? You know what I mean? And look at the lighthouse over there, the building. We cannot see anybody on the other side of that. So we're going to have somebody in a vehicle driving around the prison at all times, checking the water line at all times.
Is that a downed airplane over there?
Yeah, it's the fire service trading area.
it's training. Oh,
control room.
I've never seen that airplane.
Temporarily off mic.
FM.
10-4, how long?
1 minute.
10-4. Alright, so you guys know what the frequency is? Do you guys know what the frequency is?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, alright. It's SD plus 70.
I can
SD plus 70.
You can't break those cuffs.
Alright, so, Lieutenant, are we going to go over the basic DOC stuff to show them what to do?
Yes, I was just got onto the contraband and then...
Cool. Okay, go ahead. Continue. Alright, continue, Lieutenant. Sorry about that.
Jay, come here and talk to me about
your... Oh, I'm actually wondering, Under Sheriff, are we loading them in from the front or where are we exactly? Are we going to load them in from the garage?
The garage.
Hey, it's 3 a.m.
Alright, roger that.
It's 3 p.m. I don't know.
Oh, we load people in from the garage, no matter what, if they're being transported by car, or...
Yeah, we take the car around back, and we open it up. That's the intake door. The garage.
Control room, intercom.
Okay, so...
AFM.
I'm gonna tell you a little about the taser, where you do use the X-26 taser. So that has... It has two prongs when you fire them out. There is... I don't know how to... In this... Fisher's Island, you do have 3 cartridges of 2 taser prongs per magazine, if you want me to call it, that makes sense. So, for each reload you have 3 shots, per se. And each shot will go about 7 to 21 feet for the optimal distance. Because if any of you guys know how they do work on other islands or the mainland, they are very inaccurate at distance. So, you get about 1 foot of... 1 foot apart for every 7 feet, so you're looking at 21 feet. You could have 3 feet. That's a human body right there, easily. So you definitely, the closer the better. Obviously, you don't want to be too close, because otherwise, then you might have ineffective, like, it hitting the body and it not actually penetrating because it didn't get enough velocity in that center. But you want to do aim for anything center mass or the lower body. You never want to aim for the head. That's the day you get in trouble. I mean, you got accidental. But that's going to have to be proven. Don't ever aim for someone's head. Even if they're trolling you, they're acting like a dick. That's the day that that's what they're looking for. They're looking for an easy way to get a paycheck from the SD, from the DOC. They just want that easy payday. And they aren't going to be, none the wise, they aren't going to get brain damage or nothing like that. They're just there looking for a easy payday. Now, on this island, the gravity does affect the taser slightly. So it isn't like an exact sniper, but you do want to make sure that you do lead a target. Like, you do have to lead the target just like you do with a bullet, but it is much, much more pronounced than you would see with a gun at, let's say, 21 feet. So make sure you keep that in mind. Do I have anyone questions about the X-26 taser?
Nope. I had my first use of it yesterday.
Very nice. Oh, I did forget to say what it does, it sends electromagnetic pulses so that the brain isn't able to communicate with the muscles and stuff, and that's why they freeze up and spasm, because they can't communicate and it's getting bad signals. I did forget that.
They yell?
It's called electromuscular disruption.
Yes, Warren.
Also, the taser, you won't really deal with it here. But possibly, I'm just saying, if they are holding a gun, firing a taser can make their finger pull the trigger. So, you know, if they're holding a gun and pointing at somebody, you know, that's not exactly when you want to be using a taser.
I'd almost say if someone is holding a gun, you do want to be holding a gun as well. That's personally what I would
do. I'm just saying FYI. Like,
yeah.
So... Just as much as you guys are, except you guys would be facing a certain direction. When we get a line of prisoners, let's just say they did arrive by helicopter, there's 3 prisoners, 3 or 4 prisoners. It was a big day. They all got transported at the same time. We would have them walk out and step. I would assume that we would tell them to come up and stand against this fence right here. And we'd be like nose and toes against the fence. At an even interval, it wouldn't be as close as you guys are now, because criminals are really good at like looking down and getting that stuff. You wouldn't notice. You think they're just, hey, digging their pockets, and bam, they're digging the guy's pockets next to them. So, make sure you have them spread out evenly, but nose and toes against it. And once you have everyone out, you have them in control, you let them know who's in a sort of voice, who's the man in charge. This is not their house no more.
Kitchen,
you would tell them, hey,
thank you.
Face, and we would... Would we search them before walking in, Warden? Or would we do that upon entering once we have a little more confined area for them not to go anywhere? Would we search them, like, out there? Or, I mean, even if they were being transported by car, like, it'd be inside against the wall somewhere?
When they first come in, there's a conveyor belt there. They'd be put against the wall and searched right there again as soon as they get in the building.
So you tell them nose and toes against that?
Yep.
After having them walk in, this is a no-run area. As you guys saw how hard it was when we were trying to walk out here, imagine if you had a bunch of guys that didn't really, like, and they're just running everywhere. That's not what we do here. We walk. It's a lot easier. So we put them up against the wall, tell them to take 3 steps backward, drop their clothes, drop everything, drop their cell phone, drop their weapon. God forbid if they actually got here and still had a weapon on their body. Drop everything. They're going to be standing there in their birthday suit, and to take a step forward, back against the wall, nose and toes, once again in their birthday suit. At that point, we would look down. We would take all their clothes, replace it with a DOC appointed clothing, whether or not, depending on what class they were. And then when we actually don't have iron stomachs or something, we would put a burger on top of that as well. We tell them, hey, take 3 steps backward, pick up your clothes and food, eat your burger, and just step back against the wall. If they don't comply, you tell them each and each, and their one isn't comply, you just let them be. You tell them you'll get back to them, and you continue on with everyone else. Because trying to barter with one guy is just, that's counterproductive, and he'll end up not having privileges later on. As the warden has told me, like he has on the mainland and everything, there was a guy that refused to cooperate and told him, he'll be back in an hour or something like that. You said you went on lunch, Warden, and
yep.
he turned the TV off. And when you're an inmate and that's all you got, people care about their TV. And they came back. He came back, and the guy was tripped. Oh, got his face busted up. And let's just say he never gave the warden any problems again. So I'm not saying that that's what we would do is take TV, but you know, there's stuff that you would do that people would enjoy. Yard time. Hey, they would spend their whole 360 months. In that prison cell over here, or they get some time out here. It's their choice how they want to act. So, you got a question, Ranger?
I'm sorry.
You got a question? I just thought you put your hand up.
Did you explain that there was the other inmates that had their stuff taken away, and the other inmates were the ones that lumped them up?
Yes, that's what.
Okay,
it's called self-correcting behavior.
That's exactly what it's called. Very good, Baxter.
Oh, we did it all the time.
Familiar with that, yeah.
Yeah. Or visitation, phone.
All that stuff.
Yeah, just they lose simple that stuff.
Yeah.
Simple stuff that we take for granted, but it's your life in the prison. And there's one guy that takes it away, you sure as hell, he's not going to be taking that away again because, you know, he's going to be reminded what happens because they... they self-correct, just like you said. So, you always want to maintain order. You want to make sure that you remind that this isn't their house. A prison cell isn't their house. You got them the mainland. Like, it's the warden's house. It's his cell. That's his clothes. That's his food. Nothing is their own. They don't own any property anymore while they're residing in the warden's prison. And that's how you want to say it. I mean, some people might want to say, like, our or whatever like that, but it's... It's the warden's prison. This is the warden's prison. So
well,
make sure that they're reminded that every single time you do that, they don't own anything anymore while they reside here. They may have money in the bank when they get out. Blah blah blah.
Thank you very much.
This is the warden's prison, and make sure that's hound home. That you're making sure that they get there safely. You're gonna take care of them, but ultimately you're residing. You're a guest at the warden's house. So. That's definitely a big thing. Okay, so. Okay, I need to talk about that.
We have to go to the hospital.
Why?
That's the goal.
So you want to definitely make sure. I briefly covered that about not letting anyone delay your job. If there's a guy that's refusing to, like I said, refusing to do anything that would delay you, just move along and come back to him. And if, every single time you have to come back to him, take something that's more important to him. You come back to him. And he asks, "Oh, what happened in yard time? What yard time? Oh, what happened to this? What visitation?
Close yard door, please."
You know, because that's stuff that you don't get. That's what people get when they cooperate with us. And they're gonna call you all these names. They're gonna call you corrupt, blah blah blah. But that just means they're doing the job. The more
stuff, because I wanted to see what the kitchen was like, and he said that since he was alone, he couldn't. Even though I gave you my word to not be cheeky beaky.
Can we please have some yard time?
Yes, I promise you guys. As soon as they're done with their training, you guys can go out to the yard. Okay.
I mean, not even the yard. Can I just see what?
Not going to be able to have that opportunity. I don't know if phone calls are going to be a thing. They're not going to get phone calls. That's all you have to do. Simple things that is going to make their 360 months, however long that you can be imprisoned here, for the max. If they do get max, whatever time they get, because they're going to be doing hard time if they come here, how they act is going to dictate how much hell they're going to have here. So when you're moving an inmate, if there's less than two, you're going to want to, it's fine for you to be by yourself. I would recommend if you got two inmates and you're all by yourself, do you have your taser out? Let's pretend that Saz and Samuel were the two inmates, and the left is the wall. You want to kind of stand a little back from them. You don't want to ever walk in line or in front of them. You always want to have eyes on in the control position, because, I mean, when you think about when people stand behind you and they're talking authoritative and stuff, you do feel like a little more under control. They might try to resist that, but, you know, they don't have that option anymore. If there's more than two mates, you're going to want to have at least two deputies there, at least, or two correctional officers.
Kitchen,
God forbid if you have more than six, then you're probably going to have three officers, and then two of those would have tasers out at that point in time. So, use of force. You would give them warning. If they're having a fight, you're going to have a sergeant, the DOC sergeant, or the highest in command at that point in time that's awake at that point. If there is no DOC, it's just manned by SD members, because we all are SD members. If it's all manned by SD members, then, you know, you'd want to look for the sergeant to be doing it. Or if there's no sergeant, the senior deputy, and he's going to be standing right there, flanked by two deputies or someone, like, let's just say it's all deputies, then one of them, you're going to take control. You're going to stand in the back. Oh, kind of like David White is. Pretend David White's the sergeant. He would stand in the back. He wouldn't have his taser out. Let's just say there's a fight. He would have view of the whole operation. So he'd be standing in the back, running his GoPro, directing the uses of force, while Sergeant Leahy and Sergeant McCloyne would have their tasers out. He'd be directing them to, oh, there's a fight. Oh, tell them to stop. White would be like, okay, stop, or you will be tased. Stop, you'll be tased. Stop fighting. Get on the ground. They want to resist. White would be like, oh, Sergeant McCloyne, Sergeant Leahy, start moving forward. They would slowly walk forward with their tasers brandished, and then they give them another opportunity. They still don't want to fight. He'd call taser, taser, taser. They would take them down. That point, on a predetermined, one of them would drop their taser. Okay, not drop it. They would holster their taser and take out their cuffs while the other one still kept their taser out. Because we always need to maintain positive control. Sergeant Leahy is covering him. McCloyne will go up and cuff both of them and move them over to separate areas so that they're not together. We don't need to see them both trying to fight each other again while they're handcuffed. At that point, because they were tased, you would get EMS at that point, just like you would do anywhere else, anywhere on this island. You call taser, you're going to also call EMS. You call EMS, get them deployed here, get them checked out. If they're fine, you definitely have them in separate cells, and you'd preferably take them further apart from each other and not bring them close together, like more than a one-cell separation, so that if they're on whisper, they can hear each other, because they like to do that. Do I have any questions on that?
Yeah, question.
Answer?
If you take someone along with calling EMS, do you also call a superior if one's not around?
Well, hopefully in that case, if there was those two, the superior would be standing in the back.
If it's the case of three deputies, would you call a superior?
I mean, we should never, like, hopefully there'd be no less than three deputies or three officers, whether it be corrections or sheriff at this at the department. So one of them is going to hopefully be either a supervisor or going to be, you know, of a of authority to do that.
Control to Ortiz. Okay.
Because at that point you would be the control supervisor. Go. The guy standing in the back, let's say David White. Let's just say for some reason he is the one that calls in. We do have
responding code 3.
Some clients aren't like he. At that point, because he is in that supervisor position, overseeing and doing all that, he would be the guy to go to.
Okay.
Because he did take the supervisor role in that. You're not going to likely see White, like, you know, issue use of force to start late and start McCloy. But let's just say that did happen. He would be the guy. He would be the guy, because let's just say he is a, let's just say he is a sergeant in the DOC, and he's just wearing his deputy uniform right now for the PD. He would be the authority on here.
So even if you outrank a DOC member in SD, that does not mean you necessarily outrank them here in DOC. There is separate DOC ranks. Like, if I were to come here and there was a DOC deputy, I'd take direction from the DOC deputy. That's how it works around right here, right now.
Yeah.
Why do we see
this? This isn't what, like, Highway Patrol and K-9, where their own ranks within Highway Patrol have no effect on the rest of it. This is its own. They're not a separate faction, but they are. They have separate rank structure that you have to abide by their rank structure.
You're gonna you'll have to check out either on the TS app, or they'll probably get
There is a faction probably for the DOC that you'd be able to identify. Like, the only guys we have right now is at this moment.
Olson Walker
time,
is lieutenant, and then Danny One I think is a sergeant, and then there's one more sergeant I think as well.
Yeah. Olson Walker is the lieutenant, and Danny One and Tony Mercenary are the sergeants. And then there is Riley Redfern, Sosa Montana, Tyler Overwatch, Tony Mercenary. Well, Tony Mercenary not again, and then James Green are all the. Oh my God!
What the fuck?
What the hell was that?
always tab out another manner than doing that.
That was a false taser, over.
I think one hit my foot. Give me a little shock.
You didn't even follow it. No, you got scared. Did you ride the lightning there? Are you okay? Is your foot okay?
I think we improved. The lieutenant is tasing cadets now.
Thank you.
No, you didn't. No one got tased. Jesus. I like that. Oh.
Mm. Whoa. I'm a little scared now, actually.
Yeah, don't tab out and have a weapon out, because otherwise it'll fire. Even if you right click in your brain, it still will fire. I found that out right now, so yeah. Don't do that. So, do I have any question on who, like, when you have a supervisor and you direct them the approach and the use of the force in that manner?
See if we have trespassers on here, Lieutenant. Is this same thing, Coast
Guard?
If you
have a trespasser on here, you'd respond the kind that... Yeah, this, a trespasser here, you would respond the same thing as a trespasser on SD.
Yep.
This is a trespassing of a government facility.
If you do have someone that requires to go to the clinic, you do have an RMR escort at that point to do that. And you would have someone roll with him there, and someone come with him back, and you would have a vehicle for that as well.
The clinic is here. Are we using this one, Keen?
Hey, Lieutenant.
Is this your one here?
Yeah, I think they'll be using the clinic here.
Well, we're done right now, Mike.
Lieutenant.
What?
I have to peace out right now.
Control room back.
I got peace out too right now.
I would not advise doing it on here. You might get locked on.
I'll move.
Ready. Hallway but opening.
That's pretty much. That's pretty much it. You'll get more direction once you actually run the DOC a little more, but that's all that was pretty much the standard training at this point.
Oh, yeah. Also, when you guys do become deputies, you're going to have a lethal weapon, but at no point is a lethal weapon ever used within the Department of
Warfare. Control, do I close hallway?
Close hallway 2, yes, please.
Control, open your door. Yard door.
Control. Open cell phone.
Yard door opening.
Need to get more lights out here.
Guys,
control.
Send me
open
a,
cell
send me a PM on the TSF so I can mark you guys off.
Control. Open cell 5.
Hallway, please.
Well, I can spot Robbie's hallway. Voice like 5 miles away.
Come on.
Oh my god, $100, that's Robbie Skipper in there, am I right?
Stakes, you gonna go
right?
With the briefing?
His name's Jake, by the way.
Yeah,
Jake Ortiz.
Yeah.
I thought it was Jack.
Okay, oh, go with Walter
the
to the briefing.
Where did
go
those
to the
guys come
okay?
From?
So is the situation here clear?
No, oh, no, wait. Rack, this guy's not eating.
Hey, what's up, boss? What's going on?
Where did all these guys come from? They
control, yard door closed.
We were in the...
Control, cell 2 and 3 also need to be closed, over.
Control, 2, 3, close.
I need Mr. Miller over there.
Thank you, control.
Hey, Keen, how would you feel if somebody, you know, like, put you inside this?
That wouldn't happen to me. McClane, are you going to close this for them?
It's more of like a willful stay.
Ramp guys, so I can close this up. Domino.
Control, hallway door is good to be closed.
Hold on. Dave.
Center 2 is 15. Do I need to give anybody a ride out of DOC?
Yes, me, I guess. Are you going to, Lubbock?
I'm calling in. Yeah, I'm going to the meeting.
Yeah, I guess I'm going to impound in my vehicle, so I gotta get to the impound lot. Hey, so hopefully...
2 Ocean 15, do I need to give anybody a ride, or they all got their own cars?
So welcome, guys. Welcome to my live stream, the boss's live stream, the Godfather's live stream.
Holy
How are you guys
fuck,
enjoying it?
There.
Yep, there is. They had a lot of cadets over there. So how you guys enjoying the live stream? Please make sure that you hit the like button and support my live stream, guys. Is there gonna be a dead chair or something? I think that's gonna be coming on a later date, William. There's still a lot to be implemented and there's still a lot to take out. So I'm just gonna say for now no to that, but you know, in the long run, who knows. So guys, make sure you hit the like button and support my live stream, guys. I would really appreciate that if you do that for me.
Oh my god, dude, I literally right. Just
close,
fucking went over
close,
all that
yard open.
For real,
you guys,
oh, there's still guys there, they can get a ride.
Damn, this charge is so glitched for me right now, like, it's just everywhere. Yeah, I can't even.
Okay, control, close yard, please.
Alright, I'll be switching back to the PD's frequency now. Can you show the Coast Guard? Hell yeah, Tyler,
yes,
Hol-
all units to Holland. Courthouse and Labark.
Yes, Tyler Holland, I'm going to be showing you Coast Guard probably in the next live stream.
Pretty AIDS lately.
And show you, things that they do. Okay, so, yeah, pretty much in the next live stream, I'm going to be showing you a little bit about the Coast Guard and stuff like that, alright? But for now, it's the prison, so, yeah.
There's a drug dealer.
How did you get here? What? Alright guys, just look right here.
That's my dude.
Man, you already know everywhere over here, man. Alright guys, if you look over here, this is the this is the home of the Coast Guard right here. I'll be showing you guys more about the Coast Guard probably in the next live stream. Thank you, Xavier, for hitting that like button. I appreciate it, dude.
Which road do you have to take to get back there?
Yeah, impound lot pretty much, trying to get my towel out. Thanks, detective. Alright.
Yeah, no problem. Wait, is it this way?
Nah, you keep going forward. At the end of this you know, you could
I just gotta loop around.
Yeah, you can stop me at a gas station. If
Lincoln 10, I'm 1076 of courthouse.
Yeah, just right here. Right here's good.
What do you mean right here?
It's way behind you right there. You just missed it.
No, that's it's right to our left.
The impound lot?
Oh, you need to go to the impound lot?
Yeah.
Oh, they're trying to go to the courthouse, dude.
Oh, yeah, I'm just going to get my towel there and probably hit there.
Okay. There you go.
Radio check.
Thanks.
Jimmy? There you go.
10-2.
Sam 21 to Lincoln 10.
Lincoln 10.
Lincoln 10, if you can delay the briefing, Sam 21 will be 1076 over to the courtroom as soon as possible.
Can you move it and focus this mark?
Love to, but it's got no fuel in it.
Estimated that funding.
Oh.
Love to move it, but it's out of fuel.
Cut at 242, 1076 to courthouse.
Where's the damn courthouse? Where's the damn courthouse? We need to go to the courthouse or something. Where's the courthouse? Last time I checked, I think it was to our left. Is that it? No, I think that's DOC. That's the West Gate. Let me check my map real quick. Don't even know what damn courthouse is right now. Let's see. Oh! Okay, yeah. Okay, this is way behind us right now, so... It's close to the sheriff's department. Right here. Yep. I think we found it.
Mary 161, 1076 courthouse.
10-4.
Cadet 226, any available deputies looking to take ride along cadets?
But what is he doing? What are you doing?
Respond to the courthouse right, for a Department of Justice briefing.
226 en route.
What? Oh my goodness. What is he doing? Jesus.
Cadet 231 is also 1076 to the courthouse.
10-4.
Potatoes 69 to Murray 161. Could you stop by at Carmen Lane's real
so
quick? I might have your uniform here.
Was like trying to like help me and everything.
10-4.
I wish the game, the made the game, well, it was like an Xbox. Yeah, it's not for Xbox style. It's for PC. If you have a PC, you could play. Yeah, if you have a gaming computer, you could definitely be able to play this game. It's Arma 3. That's the name of the game, and the server is Project Life. So yeah. So guys, if you're wondering where I am right now, this is the City Hall. Welcome to the Fishers Island City Hall right now. So, we just have some briefing to do in the City Hall in here.
I posted me.
Like that. Oh, it's Logan.
Well, where's everyone at?
This.
Oh, there they are.
My brother.
Oh.
Ready.
So this is the courtroom right now, guys. So this is where people actually
Can I have yours?
Yeah. Like, Brady.
Guys, whisper. Jesus.
Brady cocking.
All right. So this is where the trials are gonna be held for criminals, violent criminals, and
I'm pulling you over.
This is how it looks. So.
Fuck a boy.
I remember pulling you over. I will remember this moment.
This guy drove a cab.
Remember guys, if you're just joining the live stream, go ahead and hit the like button and support my live stream. I'll appreciate that, guys. I will really appreciate that, guys, if you hit the like button for me. And stay tuned for more live stream
Can I have your name?
On this channel. And yeah, we could get it kicking.
No.
That's exactly what I was
No.
Triggered.
It does have the right to remain silent.
And I'm kind of triggered about that.
My mom always makes that bomb ass food.
What happened, James?
With a badge number called Potato 69. I'm Paul 69, so I'm kind of triggered about that.
Wish I was Potato 69.
You have a few more coming, you said, Sergeant.
At one point, there was three Paul 83s. It's all good.
It's Lieutenant.
That was crazy.
Lieutenant Callan now. Oh, man.
But I'm the original one, so it's all good.
What's your first name, Lieutenant Callan?
Charles Paul 69.
I'm Paul 83.
There was some call about a sheriff getting a gun named at him.
Hey, James, you ain't got no clothes on. Don't have to do it.
Remember when I accidentally tried to swivel the laptop and I turned the radio?
Does it look better or what?
Yeah, it's just going to be kind of casual. I'm just going to explain what's going on, how it's going to work.
Back is lower, the sheriff thing.
He's scared. He was like, dude, I'm going to get fucking kicked out. I'm never going to join the cop force now.
I mean, if the officers are here, that's great. But at least if the supervisor is here, they can disseminate the information down.
Bad
dude. And it'll be pretty simple, but I just want to make sure everyone's on the same page.
Highway Patrol soon,
hopefully. Well, I got you here.
Who is this bum pulling out the rusty crown back?
Good to see you back, Estona. Love you, dude.
Thoroughly. Okay, fantastic.
Well, the rest of the trespass on government property.
I kind of enjoy District 1 anyways, to be honest.
Excuse
me, lie.
No, I mean, I've been in here a little bit today.
There was a 911 call that,
it was kind of canceled sometimes.
So hot and fucking sweat.
Yeah, most of the time, like 90%.
I'm really sweating.
I don't know how everybody's supposed to be here.
Okay, I was just letting you know.
Okay. There was a sheriff handing out guns and
No, there was a call about a sheriff having a gun aimed at me.
Did you hear your name again? Sorry.
It's the David.
I mean, nothing over the radio.
I think that's a false call.
I think so, too.
Yeah.
David, you're from Germany, right?
Considering I didn't hear anything
He's from the UK.
Wasn't serious, anyway. It was kind of a meme.
Like, walk out there and see SD. So, yeah.
Estona, no, it's not training. It's a meeting with, the new DOJ. So... the new DOJ have been implemented, and so you know.
Really, you guys are fucking cops, and you're acting like
somebody
asked me
this. I think Germany.
We're trying to talk to the new DOJ director. You know, he has some new stuff for us, and we're just trying to know, you know, how DOJ is going to work in conjunction with the sheriff department to get, you know, everything running and stuff like that. But yeah, it's not training. Is there a mayor and a secret service? Yes, sir, Sir William. There's a mayor and there's a secret service.
Gonna make this quick before the civilians realize we're all here and they're gonna be trolling around.
I know. Yeah, it won't be like an hour or two. It's pretty simple. I just want to make sure everybody knows what's going on.
Is a law change? Gotta be.
Alright, there.
Foot fell asleep.
You really don't need to slurp your soup in the mic every 2 seconds.
Yeah, that'd be great.
One of those deputies over there.
I have to start doing food checks like a movie theater.
No food!
There's a couple more things. While we're here, so possible maybe get like a lower price for wrenches.
See, Andy, it'd be cool.
No, not like the mayor.
Database on one of his laptops.
I've been saying
with the SD
here in the front desk. Yeah,
oh, for free.
I just paid 4,000 for it, and he said that that's all in the works, as well as being able to sit in all of these chairs. Perfect. All the chairs, all the benches will have seats like the movie theater when you go in. You can sit down.
Perfect.
Yeah, that's gonna be nice.
32, James.
Eventually, there's also some new ones in the prison too.
No,
while we're waiting here, what critiques do you have about the uniform?
But I'm talking,
boy. Your problem.
About the uniform you've got on right now?
And the black ones, yes. The
guy felt sorry for me. Uniform you've got on right now.
Hey, Deputy, I'm not able to hear any of them. Can you stop, please?
I don't like the badge.
I don't do anything.
Talking much less. Yes, anyways.
It's gonna be three-dimensional.
No, no, no.
It's
gonna
be a badge soon.
That's what I'm talking about.
You guys are deputies, and yet I feel like I'm older than you.
Ready to play.
Where a sheriff looks like an Abercrombie.
Some of us are a little different, Matt, okay?
stretch over your 12.
I know,
supermodel.
I mean, come on, your deputies are setting examples for me.
I know, but if I be 120% serious every 2 seconds, this is going to get real boring real quick.
It's true, too.
Yeah, see? I'm sure once he's talking to everyone, we'll all shut up, so.
I just couldn't tell if he was talking to anybody, I guess.
No.
I think that's good.
He'd be a little louder.
Other than that, what's on your other sleeve? Sheriff logo? Yeah.
Same thing.
The only Lieutenant, one that, that should be everyone.
Tactical medic uniform. Stacy, come here real quick. Looks like a
mermaid. Excuse me.
So she just got the new tac medic uniform.
Jackson is a mermaid.
Oh, that's sheriff medic. Nice.
Where is Miller?
Looking fresh.
Yeah, that looks sheriff good. Medic. I like that.
Those looks kind of linty though. What's with all the, well, the white circles?
Looks good.
Kind of. That looks pretty warm. Swaggy, dude.
Yo, Jason.
Shoulders.
If you look on her uniform, the medic is like the medic's fine.
The medic's
the sheriff is.
But I think if you just lower
maybe
the.
Maybe if you lower the sheriff.
Yeah,
like,
lower
the
lower the size of it.
To look like the 101st Airborne patch on the side.
All right. So is that everyone here?
That's everybody here. Yep. Go ahead and get started.
Okay.
Oh,
so,
what is Kane now?
I stand over here because I want to look. I want to look fancy. There we go.
Kane, shut up. So, for all of you who don't know me already, my name is Andy Hicks. I'm the new acting Chief Justice. Hello.
Hello.
We're gonna do basically a dry run tonight, or a trial run, of the new justice system. This is gonna be a simplified version of it, just to kind of familiarize people with the process that's coming, as well as to kind of test the system to make sure if there's any flaws that need to be worked out, we can work those out before we set everything in stone. Because I'll be honest, it's a lot of writing, and Oscar's fingers are getting tired. So, what? Then, get out! So, what we're going to do is, when you arrest somebody in the field now, again, this is just for tonight, for the next few hours. When you arrest somebody in the field, you'll bring them back to the sheriff's department. Just like you normally would, you're going to Mirandize them and do all that. You'll list their charges. Once they have charges, you're not going to ask them how they plead there. You'll bring them here before me for sentencing. So what will happen is they'll come in. Everybody will be sworn in by a bailiff or me, depending on whether or not there's a bailiff available. From that point, they'll be sworn in, we'll go over the charges and what's there. There's not going to be really a description of what happened or anything like that. It'll just be simply, how would you like to plead to these charges? If they want to plead guilty, then we'll go over some brief circumstances. I'll ask you a few questions about, what the circumstances were, just a brief synopsis. Whether or not they were cooperative with you, that's going to be a big one. Just different little questions like that, and then I'll determine a sentencing for time. At that point, if they do plead guilty, they'll be sentenced to a time, in which case you can transport them out to the prison. If they plead not guilty, fine. What we'll do is you'll take them back to the sheriff's department and put them in a holding cell. We'll give you time to contact legal representation for them, if any is available. If not, they have the option always to represent themselves. And that also gives you time to put together the evidence for a case. Once that's all together, you'll come back here. If there's not an active case going on or whatnot, essentially, we'll kind of, you'll figure it out. You'll just kind of wait your turn in here, and you'll come up, you'll explain, you know, this is such and such, yada, yada, yada. BS, BS, and we'll move forward into kind of an abbreviated version of a trial, where we'll go over evidence. It'll have standard courtroom procedures. Just for those of you who don't know, I'll give you a brief rundown, so pay attention. If you learn nothing else from this, learn this. Basic procedures in a courtroom. First, you'll have identification of persons. So I'm going to ask who the prosecution is, who the defense is, and who the legal representation for each case is.
Poll, do we have any
point, you'll have opening statements. And general rule of thumb in court is prosecution always goes before defense. They're always going to do the first thing. And essentially, court is just mimicking. The prosecution will make a case, the defense will try and poke holes in it. Prosecution will make another case, the defense will try and poke holes in the case. That's court, essentially. It's just back and forth banter. So, there'll be opening statements, prosecution, then defense. prosecution will call evidence or witnesses. Then defense will have a chance to re-examine them. Defense will then cause or call defense will call evidence or witnesses. Then the prosecution has a chance to cross-examine them. Then you have closing statements. The prosecution makes a closing statement. Defense makes a closing statement. At that point, the trial is over. I'll take a recess and render a verdict. At that point, it's just like sentencing. They'll get a verdict, guilty or not guilty, fines, jail time, all that, and then they'll be transported. Okay. So I know that was a lot of information. I will help you guys out. If you're not familiar, need a refresher or something, let me know. I'll pull you aside. We'll go over it again. Other than that, does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, right here.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll start from the left.
Just to confirm, there's no jury. You guys are just doing the verdicts?
So, as of right now, there is no jury. We do have plans in the future to implement a jury system for capital offenses, such as first-degree felonies, capital murder, items like that. But as of right now, I highly doubt you're going to be dealing with a lot of that tonight. If you do, we will not be doing a jury case. It will be just a judge case.
All right, that's all. Thank you.
Sir, with the taser. Oh, okay, Vladimir.
Yeah, do we take people that have to go to prison to Coast Guard, or I haven't done that before, so...
We'll take them to the actual prison facility. That's based on your SOPs. I'm not super familiar with what Rockford has planned right now, but that's... Essentially, the Sheriff's Department will be a holding facility, kind of a transitional stage between going from arrest to first court, or what's called arraignment, and then going from arraignment to trial. Once they're sentenced and they have an actual jail time to serve, then they'll be taken to the actual prison facility to serve out their jail time.
Okay, and also one more thing?
I have a question.
Oh, wait, never mind, they moved the prison, I see. I got no more.
Rush up, Vladimir, you're behind.
Yes, yeah, sorry.
So is video evidence, I thought that was inadmissible in court, or we to edit and upload...
Video is absolutely admissible in court. In fact, I prefer video.
Okay, because I'm having trouble editing. So if I have to upload like a 30-minute video, is that okay? Just to save time? I'll tell you like where the timestamp is.
It's fine. When it comes to evidence like that, I've had people upload 6-hour videos before. And what they do is their evidence, they submit chunks of the video as evidence. So you'll have Exhibit A is timestamp 320 to 356. Exhibit B is timestamp, 427 to 538. Like that. And that way it speeds up court, but make sure you have all those timestamps together if you're going to do a video that large.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, who else had a question over here?
So if there's not a lawyer available for prosecution, who does prosecution? If there's no lawyer available for prosecution, who does prosecution?
So you will be the prosecutors in these cases for tonight. That's going to let everybody kind of get familiar with court and how it works. And I do not expect you guys to be perfect. I will correct mistakes if... I do seem kind of harsh when I'm correcting mistakes. It's not because I hate you. There's only a couple of you I hate. Just kidding. But it's just to make you all better at what you do. Because in all reality...
One of them hates me, TBH.
Pretty much. So in all reality, it's something that takes a lot of time to learn. I don't expect you all to pick it up overnight. Once this is done and we kind of get a procedure and how we feel it's going to work the best and flow easiest and quickest for everybody, then you'll have kind of a set standard. But for right now, if you don't understand something or somebody calls an objection you don't understand, all you got to do is say, Your Honor, may I approach the bench? At that point, I'll say yes. You walk up to the bench here, make sure you're whispering so not everybody hears it. Just say, I don't understand what that means, and I'll explain it to you briefly. Then you can go back and we'll continue on. I don't have a problem with that. I'd much rather you guys, if you have a question, ask it versus coming in and making the Sheriff's Department, no offense, look like idiots. Because it's very easy to do in court. Now, there are certain circumstances where you may think you have all the evidence in the world and I rule not guilty. You gotta understand, that's part of court as well.
Saying what?
My job is to be completely impartial. So, my job is to look at nothing but the evidence provided. I don't care if you saw the guy do it. If you don't have evidence of it, or you don't have a testimony that can attest to that, I can't throw him in jail for it. That makes sense? So I have to go by the hard evidence that's presented in court, and that's the only thing I can go by.
If he pleads guilty, then we don't need to show you evidence for it, don't we?
So what'll happen is that's the initial arraignment. So once you get them back there, you figure out their charges, you come in. When you bring them here, the first thing it'll be is we'll call it a preliminary hearing or an arraignment hearing, which is where they come in, and essentially what'll happen is, hopefully, if Jackson sticks around, I'm going to get him kind of in the role of bailiff for right now, so you'll see how it's supposed to work. And you'll come in, you'll see the bailiff first, he'll get all the information, bring it to me, and that'll become something on the docket, what it's called, which is basically a list of things that need to happen in court. So the docket will be presented. He'll say this is case, you know, Fisher's Island versus, for right now, Cane Potato. Okay? And we'll proceed with there. And I'll say prosecution, please state your name for the court. Prosecution will state their name. Defense, please state your name for the court. They'll state their name. Okay? The case of Fisher's Island versus Cane Potato is now in session. Prosecution, what are the charges being presented against Cane Potato? And they'll say 3 counts of first-degree murder of a law enforcement officer. I'll say, okay, Mr. Potato, how do you plead to those charges? And he will say either guilty or not guilty.
It's me.
That's pretty much it. Obviously, when it's Cane, he'll be guilty. No doubt about it. So, as he runs away. You know, if they plead guilty, that's when we'll go through sentencing. I'll ask you the basic questions, and we'll be done. If they plead not guilty, yeah, see, there he goes. He already knows his home. If he pleads not guilty, we'll move forward. During arraignment, there's another thing I forgot. Thank you for going in there, Cane. You just reminded me. During arraignment, when you bring somebody in, you're going to be standing here right next to him, kind of like you two are right here. Okay, when you bring somebody in for a trial, they will go into the defense box. We'll be in there. And what that is, that's a preventative measure to make sure that if they are found guilty of a crime, don't freak out and try and kill everyone. They can smash their head against that glass as hard as they want. They're not getting out, I promise. I've tried. So, that's that. And again, all that will be listed here shortly. Hopefully in the next couple days we'll have all that together for you. Yes, James.
Okay, so as far as DOJ is concerned, am I able to tell a suspect, you know, if you tell me what happened, I'm not going to arrest you? He admits to everything, and then I get another officer to arrest him instead.
That is kind of a gray area. Depending on circumstances, which are a case-by-case basis, that could be considered entrapment. However, in other circumstances, it's not, if it's part of an ongoing investigation. I would prefer if you didn't go up to somebody and say, if you tell me what happened, just be honest, I won't arrest you. And they say, yeah, well, I shot him because I had to. You go, okay, put your hands behind your back, you're done. Like, you just admitted to it, haha. Like, that's... Is it technically legal?
No, it's not.
Most of the time, sometimes, believe it or not, it is sometimes. However, it's being a total douche, and I'd prefer if you didn't do that, because okay, that's not going to make you look good in the eyes of the court.
Most states consider that coerced.
Yes. But again, it's circumstantial. It literally, actually, it's hard to say yes or no. It's literally a case-by-case basis, the exact words that were used, things like that. All right, back over to my left here. Caden, yes.
I'm not Caden.
Would you yell?
Can you yell?
Oh, okay.
Yes. Just yell.
I move behind you so I can be noticed. Anyways, how long can we leave him in a in the holding
cell
to prepare for evidence? Because I know, let's say, I know some of us have kind of slow, you know, connections to the Matrix and to the government website, and they'll say something like, "Oh, it's going to take me like 6 hours to get this uploaded," or something.
So what I'd prefer on that is if you know it's going
to
take
out a whisper.
I can hear him. If it's going to be a ridiculous amount of time. For anybody who didn't hear him, what he asked was, if it's going to take 6+ hours to get the evidence together, what do I do? At that point, we do have a bond form. And what will happen is they can be released on bond. They can pay a certain amount to the court as kind of a guarantee policy that they will show back up for trial. And what will happen is when they show back up for trial, that money will be returned to them. I do have a bond form here. However, it's not available for you guys yet. I still need to get with your sheriff and figure out who is and isn't going to be eligible to issue bond. But for the time being, I'd prefer if we try to avoid that just for tonight. Again, once these few hours go by and we try this out, after that, it's going to go back to the way it was. This is almost kind of an experiment to make sure everything's going to work properly. So after I say, okay, we're done with that, you go back to the way you were doing it before. We're going to sit down over the next day or two, kind of get everything together, and then we'll pull everybody in again and do a training session, hand you all documents and things like that that you can use for reference. So for tonight, if it is going to be like that, let's just do the best we can to present evidence in court. If you can't present evidence, for instance, video, maybe doing screenshots of your video feed would be acceptable. In certain circumstances, say you're trying to show possession of a firearm, if you can take a picture of your video that has him with the firearm in his hands, that can very well show possession. But it doesn't always have to be video, unless there's a deliberate action or something like that. Sometimes pictures or sequence of pictures can show what happened to. So, and again, if you're not sure, come talk to me and we'll get that figured out.
Couple questions.
Anybody else?
So, do defendants have the option of pleading nolo contendere in court here, or is it just guilty and not guilty for one?
Yes, they do have the option of pleading nolo contendere. However, essentially, for the purposes of what we do here, it will basically be a guilty plea, just because of the fact they're pleading no contest.
Right.
They're essentially saying, there's overwhelming evidence against me, there's no point in me wasting the court's time. However, pleading nolo contendere will benefit them in sentencing, because right. they're not going to waste the court's time.
And that's typically why they do it.
Exactly. And they will still have to come here for arraignment, at which point they can enter that plea if they wish.
Okay. And then second question, as far as if we get a extremely non-compliant person in the courtroom where they're argumentative and don't listen to the judge's direction and don't want to listen to the officer or anything like that, is that going to still be attempted to carry out a standard case, or at that point are you just going to go straight to sentencing? How are you going to deal with that?
So, obviously I have the lovely power of contempt of court and bench warrants. So if somebody becomes irate, becomes disrespectful, I will call the court to order. If they refuse to come to order, then they will be held in contempt of court. What that is, for you guys who don't know, we'll say, for instance, because Kane is at my bench, say he runs up to me at the bench and starts getting irate, like he normally does. At that point, I would hold him in contempt of court. That is a charge that carries a determined amount of time that I make somewhere between 0 and 30 months. If he's just being a douche, I might give him 5 months, just so he has to go to prison for 5 months. If he's being a total asshole, he might get 30. It's completely based on what I think. At that point, that charge is done. If I hold him in contempt, he is to be taken into custody. Usually that is done by the bailiff if they are here, but for the purposes of what we're doing tonight, that will be done by whoever the officer is in the room, or if there is an available officer in the room to do it. They'll be taken into custody. At that point, there is no trial for that or anything. That's a bench order, and they are to be put in jail for the prescribed amount of time.
So for tonight, we are representing ourselves as prosecution.
For tonight, you will be. There is a district attorney's office that will be firing up here very soon. We're just trying to make sure we have the right people in place to make sure that gets off the ground smoothly. I'm talking to a few people who have experience with it, and then they're going to be working hand-in-hand with you guys, district attorneys and state prosecutors, to help you guys out in preparing for court, getting trials together, how to handle evidence, all that kind of stuff. And they will be prosecuting cases for you. Tonight, you're representing yourselves.
Okay, and then last question. Are deputies to leave defendants in handcuffs when they come into court, or are we just going to unhandcuff them and hope they cooperate?
If they have been, I will leave that to deputy discretion. if they've been completely cooperative with you guys, it's somebody you got for, it's their fourth traffic violation, and you're bringing them in for a criminal charge for it, or have their license revoked or whatever. For that kind of thing, if it's a nonviolent crime and they've been cooperative, once you get them here, you can take them out of handcuffs. If they just shot five people, please, for the love of God, keep them in handcuffs.
Okay.
I really don't want somebody who just shot six people running around.
That's
my
why I wanted to see what your thoughts were on that, because we don't want to take them in handcuffs if that's the case.
And so you are aware, myself and the other judges and justices will, 90% of the time, we will be armed. Law enforcement is allowed to be armed. Anybody else that comes in here is not allowed to be armed in the courtroom, period. If they are seen with a firearm in the courtroom, I don't care who the law enforcement entity or officer is, they're to immediately be taken into custody.
Okay.
There will be a criminal code about it soon, about having firearms in the courthouse. But so you know, if things do go south, be careful, because bullets might be flying from my stand towards the crowd as well.
Okay.
Samuel.
So, just to clarify then, what is being done to prevent people from entering the court with guns? Will there be searches before people come into the courtroom in the future, or is that not being addressed?
In the future, yes. For tonight, if you see people entering the courtroom, feel free to stop them and act as a bailiff. You guys have jurisdiction here tonight as well, until we get the bailiffs all in and trained and everything like that. In the future, though, when people do enter the courtroom, when there's a judge, there will be a bailiff here that will be doing searches of everybody coming into the building.
Can you go deal with that, Jack?
Thank you.
Did you say that law enforcement officers won't be allowed their weapons?
No, law enforcement will be allowed their weapons.
Yeah,
law enforcement, district attorney members, and judges and justices will be allowed firearms in the courtroom. No citizen will be allowed firearms.
Including defense attorneys are not allowed?
Defense attorneys are not allowed. Nobody or anyone who doesn't carry an official government position. For instance, like, there will be a clause in there that the mayor is allowed to have one whenever we have another mayor. Things like that. People who hold a high office in government will be allowed to protect themselves at all times. That's another thing I'm working on. I'll get into that with more detail. I got to talk to the federal government about that. But I am actively pushing to try and get some sort of weapons laws and policies in place to not only govern, but also allow the lawful carrying of weapons. Hopefully we can get that worked out soon. James.
Okay, so let's say we arrest somebody. It says, say, 45 minutes to get all the evidence ready. Is that going to be time served? Like, are we able to detain them for the amount of time that it takes us to prepare the case?
So you can detain somebody for, I believe right now, I'll have to double check, but I'm pretty sure you can detain somebody for up to an hour. That is for arraignment. Once they are arraigned, if they decide they want to go to court, they can be held indefinitely until court. However, I will keep that reasonable. I'd like to not hold anybody for more than 45 minutes to an hour at the max. After that, if it's not going to be ready in that amount of time, go ahead and let me know, and we'll file bond paperwork so they will have an order to appear in court at a future date. If it is a very serious offense, they may be remanded to the jail for holding until their trial. Yes. Go ahead.
Yes, Your Honor. How do we get a court date for them? Do we just talk to you, or do we just bring them in here?
For tonight, hopefully we won't have too many of those. In the future, the bond paperwork will be filed, and then that will go on to the forums, and a judge will take the case at that point, and a court date will be set. They'll communicate. Basically, it'll be out of your hands at that point for the most part. They'll communicate with the state prosecutors, the defense attorneys, come to a conclusion of when it's convenient for everybody to come hear the case in court. And then everybody will show up here at whatever date and time they come together on.
All right. Thank you, Your Honor.
What else? Okay, cool. Go get them, boys.
All
right, okay. Thank you. Oh, yeah, finally.
You guys have any questions or anything, get a hold of me. And I can
69 Savage.
Oh,
we out
one more thing real quick. One more thing. Hey, James, you're a perfect example. Don't come into my courtroom naked for court.
I've got kicked your ass in my eyes, so.
No, yeah, but make sure somebody looks at you.
Alright, guys, thank you for hanging with me over there. I know that was, you know, that was hell for you guys. Some people were like, when is he going to patrol? Can he get on patrol already? Well, what are they talking about? They're taking a long time. So, I'm going to get on patrol right now for you guys. Yeah, I know that was like 25 minutes of hell just simply talking for... You know, just mainly saying some bullshit over there. Oh yeah, it's for a good course, guys. All right, so let's just get back on patrol. Well, yeah, you know, DOJ just got implemented, and they're basically just telling us, you know, what is going to be happening from now on. So apparently, when we arrest someone, we have to schedule a court date for them. They can be taken out on bail or bond, like they call it, but you know, I call it bail. So. After being bailed out, then and a court date has been scheduled, they could come back to court, which they're going to be processed, and a trial is going to be held for them to go back to jail. Simple as it is. Alright, guys, I'm just gonna get ready for this patrol right now. Turn on my laptop. Turn on my speed reader and have that on right now. Hold on for me, guys. Hey, ish. Oh, there we go.
Oh.
Yeah. Turn that on right now.
A wrench, right?
Focus our signs.
What the same hill? Oh, I got a wrench on me. Nothing to see here, sir. We're just doing our job. Someone just smoked us.
Some 22 should be tonight.
What do you mean?
Paul 68, plus 1, 10-8, District 2. What
the fuck? This guy just came out of the bushes, dude.
Hey, what's up? Oh, it's good. We got a repair man.
Jeff, you repairing it?
Sam 5, 22.
Go for Sam 22.
Are you available to come to DOC at the moment?
10-4, I'll be en route to DOC.
10-4, thank you.
Alright, guys, they want to see us at DOC. Let's go know what's going on.
Lincoln 10, 10-8, District 1.
Sam 21, show me 10-8, District 2.
10-4.
Cadet 226, any available deputies willing to take a ride along?
Lincoln 10, Sam 21, can you take that ride along?
10-4.
Cadet 226, my 1020 is at the courthouse.
Cadet, go ahead and make your way down the road. I'll wait for you here. I'm in the marked Tahoe.
10-4.
Mary 161, 10-8.
10-4. Lady at the hotel coming 10-8, currently in District 1, gonna move up 3 and 4.
Sam 22, 1026, prison.
10-4.
Like the 20th time you asked.
Do you have any guns?
Alright guys, we just arrived at jail. Let's go see what's what the problem is. Let's go talk to someone. Alright. Let's switch to the DOC frequency right now. 722 DOC, I'll be on scene. Momentarily.
Careful, I'll be right there.
Excuse me?
I'll be waiting for you, at the front desk.
I'm hungry!
Hold on, you gotta wait a minute or two, okay?
Where's Rockford?
Don't worry about it.
He's like, where's
Can
Rockford?
Can I go outside?
Yeah, Rabbi is claiming that he's hungry and I can't get out of his room on me,
Hey man, what's going on?
I don't know if you're able to, or a mayor, to do some training, because I'm doing some training here.
I'm coming, so you better wait.
Training for DOC?
I'm
doing training for DOC.
Are
you able to do some training for a few of the people like Mark Young that are currently waiting?
Oh, you mean for day 3?
I'm not 100% sure what days they need because he messaged me. Let me see, hold on.
Yeah, this is the problem I had. I've been told by Lieutenant Miller that we need to do the days the way they are. So today is going to be day 3. It's only a time, you know. We still have like one more hour and 9 to be able to do it. So if they need day 5, they have to wait till day 5 to be able to get it. So today is going to be day 3. Yeah, so let them know if they, because yeah, they keep doing that. They keep texting, you know, the sergeants to know if they will be able to do the days, but just let them know.
Sorry, I'm back. Yeah, that worked.
Just let them know that, you know, they have to wait till the days to be able to do their, the training. So today is day 3, tomorrow is day 4, and on Thursday is going to be day 5.
Alright, let me just get in touch with those people and let them know, alright?
Alright, no problem, Sergeant.
Are you available to do it, or are you busy?
I'm currently busy right now with patrol, because, you know, they wanted us to go on patrol, so. But, I'm going to be hopping out and to do the training by 9. P.M.
Yeah.
Eastern time.
Okay.
Eastern time. For day three.
Alright, so I'll let them know at least 9 o'clock you'll be available or a little later than 9. Just give you some time.
Alright, no problem. Thanks.
Alright, thank you so much.
No problem. No problem, Sergeant. Alright, guys, let's just switch back to our tactical radio.
Disregard last.
Sparks, I'm Skipper.
Situation is code 4.
I don't know. They didn't set a timer. No, they said they would have to do it differently.
Estonian, I'm really sorry for not showing you the maximum prison, but this is all we have right now for the prison. The rest are going to be updated in a later date. We have to go on patrol, and we have to go on patrol real quick. So yeah, let's just head on patrol right now. Sam 22 will be back on patrol. District 2. Alright, so we have the highways to do today. No, you know what? Actually, yeah, District 2 is not the highways, but we just have the highways to do today. Let me just turn on that radio volume up, yeah, 250. So it doesn't interrupt us when we actually speaking. But yeah, I just need to get back on patrol and obviously see how we do. Yeah, Estoner, the prison, that's all we have right now for the prison because, you know, we won't be making, like, too much arrests today. But, you know, on a later date, they're going to be updating the prison to a more better and maximum prison than that. I just want to say, keep making your videos. Oh, thank you so much, Officer Trevor, or Trev. Yeah, thank you so much, Officer Trev. I appreciate it, dude, for watching my videos. I appreciate it. He looks to be driving on the wrong side of the road. I don't know why, but, you know, they always have same excuse for it. You know, the metrics is laggy. That's what I'm driving. Let's just get back on patrol and see what we can get ourselves into right now. Robbery at bank. 722 be responding to bank.
Lincoln, keep in mind the bank becomes a god issue.
Okay. 10-4, 722, disregarding.
Negative, don't disregard, go ahead and respond. I'm gonna make contact and let them understand the situation.
Whole idea, the call is kind of insane, but doesn't look like there's any robberies going on here. No one may be really leaving the area.
10-4.
Oh, I'm gonna hit those guys right now. Bank looks good right now. There's a robbery at the bank. I can't find anyone over here.
Is it even
Lincoln 10, all units can disregard your 10-8. There's a false call apparently.
10-4, something to show me back 10-8. Man, after we responded like half a mile and then, you know, it was a false call. That's some bullshit. I hate when that shit happens.
This is Cadet 203 to Jason.
This is Lincoln 10, go ahead.
Any... Yeah, I'm trying to read the comments and then... Any unmarked unit vehicle in Project Life? Yes, yes, Officer Trev, there are unmarked vehicles being driven by the detectives or the lieutenant or the sheriff. So pretty much command drives a unmarked of any vehicle that we have. So yeah, so from a lieutenant up can drive an unmarked.
00001-82M.
If you're stuck out in the middle of the ocean, you should contact the admins.
can either call Coast Guard or you can deal with that with the gods. It's up to you.
10-4.
Oof. That was good. Sam 22, Shimmy 1038, White Cranvick, almost the Avenue, Okuba Times 1, no backup needed. Alright guys, so we caught him driving without his light at night. We're just going to talk to him and see what's going on. Hello sir, how are you doing tonight?
Good, how are you?
Good, Sergeant Jimmy LaHaye with the Fish Island Sheriff Department. You know the reason why I put you over?
I do not.
You were not using your lights while driving at night. I didn't see your lights actually on back there.
Oh yeah, you're totally right. Yeah, I don't have them on, I'm sorry.
Alright, do you have your driver's license with you? Can I get your driver's license, registration? Thanks.
Yep, give me 1 second. There you go.
Mr. Archer, all right, sit tight for me. I'll be right back with you, okay?
No problem.
Alright, so he got no counts, no crime, nothing. I'm just gonna, you know, issue him a warning.
What up, blood? Just
hello.
Abide the law. We a law-abiding citizen. Fuck the police.
Alright, we're just gonna give him a warning and let him go. So, yeah. Alright, sir. Here's your driver's license back. I'm just gonna be issuing you a warning at this time. Make sure you use your lights 2 hours before sundown, okay?
Thank you, sir. I appreciate your time.
Alright, good. Because next time it's going to be a $200 ticket.
Okay, not a problem. I think it's time for officer.
Alright, thanks. Be safe.
You too.
Sam 22, code 4 from the 1038. Show me back tonight. Yeah, that was a good one, guys. So, let's get back on patrol. Yes, Officer Trevor, the computers do work right now, as you saw back there. Yeah, they do work, so. They're actually functional right now. And we can use them to, you know, track warrants and history
on your clinic. What on people. No backup needed.
Whoa, what the, man, you know. I don't want to pull him over. He's just going to say the same thing as the metrics. Okay, that officer is not using his lights. I don't think he knows, but, yeah. Well.
Alright,
Yes, sir. Officer Trev, we can run plates. We can issue warrants. We can check for ID, background check, prior histories on people, histories on their tickets, warning, arrest. You know, so we could do that using the police computer. Yes, we can. Definitely. It's all functional. It's just like. Real life, you know. In real life, they do that. They can check for history, warrants, tickets, inside tickets, warning, and stuff like that using the laptop. So it's the same over here. Everything works. So I'm gonna be heading down to Stony Creek to see if we have any you know. If we have any if we have anything going on in Stony Creek. I'm kind of new to Project Life, and sorry, I'm trying to drive and read your comment, and I have no clue how to get out of my house. Okay, well, telling you. Okay, I'm fine. Because I'm trying to read your comment and drive, and that's stressful right now. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you this. If your mind is a keyboard, you can press E. You could get out your, you go to your inventory, and you're gonna see where it says your key to your motel is right there. You click on the key, and you after clicking on the key, you. I think you click use and stuff like that, and then you can get out of your apartment. So it's gonna look like this, just watching me do it. Inventory, the motel key is right there, grab it and then open the door, and then you can get out. Pretty much that's how you do it. But yeah, I'm not supposed to tell you that. You're supposed to know how to do it by yourself. So UGC, I'm looking for sheriff other. Yeah, I was looking for
what's
this
the,
one.
Coast Guard 3.
The supervisor. Yeah.
Yes, you nasty.
Guys, look at that. I just changed my skin. Yay. Officer Travers, go to Armor 3 Project Life YouTube channel. They have tutorials. Okay, yes, exactly. They do.
Right along with somebody,
they do.
He needs a pickup. Thank you.
Yep, they do. Exactly. Oh yeah, someone. Okay, let me just show you guys the skin, show you guys how it looks. It looks fantastic. I love this skin so much. It was made by our lieutenant. Look at that. It's the supervisor skin. It's amazing. S20. I don't know if sergeants are allowed to use this. I think we are. I don't know. The last time I checked, I forgot. Yeah, but this is the skin, you know. Looks amazing. Sorry, I actually turned down my what's it called, my textures. But I'm gonna show you guys that the what's it called? The spotlight actually works on this vehicle. So just gonna show you guys that in a bit when I pull the next person over. We're definitely gonna use that. The Godfire, sorry for that link. Oh no problem though. It's totally cool. You could, you know, you could help people over here. You could paste links if you want. You know, that's fine. There's nothing to be sorry about, dude. We're all family in here. So yeah, you can totally help people out, man. Yeah. I'm not gonna be like other YouTubers that they're just gonna be like, no, you can't paste link because it's my YouTube channel. No. You're free to, you know, paste your link, help people, you know, show people stuff if you want to. It's totally fine. So this is Stony Creek right now, and you know, we're just looking around, you know, just trying to see. I think you can, but I don't know if you can add a spotlight to the other side, but I think you can. I haven't tried it though, because I just like one spotlight, you know. I haven't really tried it, but I will. Pretty soon.
Pulse 69, does anybody have any extra weapons and tasers? That's all my inventory. I just got my uniform back, that's all.
And then look at guns for a camo Ford F-150, left without paying for his repairs. That's what my bro.
Cadet 231 plus 1, we have a 1038 on a blue Camaro, just off the MSR.
But no backup needed up here?
No backup needed. What's your Jet 720? Backup. No backup needed. Yeah, what's your exact 1020? Sorry, you broke up when you were saying. South Farm? South Farm. Yeah, 10-4, on the route. Head to me.
I wonder where he's going, code 3. Oh yeah, I think he said he needs backup. Oh, that's why. Alright, cool. And I think I have someone else not using his lights again, which we're going to be giving tickets for right now. I can't find his lights on. And then he's going off-road. Look at that, carelessly driving. So step back into your vehicle, drive off the charger, step back into your vehicle right now.
Driver transported.
Drive off the charger, step back into your vehicle. Driver, step back into your vehicle.
I think he's dead.
I think he's dead.
The hearing aids must have fallen out.
Hey you, driver. You, on the red shirt, step back into your vehicle right now.
I think he's going to take off.
Right sir, now. Step back into your vehicle. Can you hear me?
Step back into
your vehicle right now. Can you hear me? Sam 22, can I get one additional to the stimulus?
He's using sign language, man.
Sir, can you hear me? Step back into your vehicle. Sir, if you don't step back into your vehicle, you're going to be tased right now. Step back into your vehicle. Sam 22, can you step that back up to the stimulus code 3? I have a more suspect that's not complying with me. Sir, step back into your vehicle right now. You're going to get tased. I'm letting you know right now. Sir, don't move. Step back into your vehicle.
Yeah, already I have told respond. I was just helping out the other unit.
Taser. Got one down. Sir, do not move right now. Do not move.
Why'd you tase me, sir? I was just...
Shut up! I said step back into your vehicle 5 times!
What?
Do not move!
Lincoln 10 and
I did not hear you. I swear to God, that's why I was saying hi, because you were looking at me. I did not hear you, I swear. Maybe my hard hearing's kicking in because of my old age.
Okay, sir, I'm just gonna place you on cuff right now. You're not under arrest, you're just being detained right now for my safety, okay?
Yes, of course, but what
just
is
stop,
it?
Just stop moving for me, sir. Stop moving. You're going
to
get tased again. Stop moving.
Oh, gosh.
What the hell is this? I was just...
Sir, you're going to get tased again. Stop moving. I'm not going to tell you again.
I'm not moving. I'm just looking at you. Oh, my Lord.
I want to get tased.
Jesus Christ, I was just trying to do coal.
Oh my lord.
Attempting to get one in custody.
He said, oh my lord.
Brutality much? Jesus, a coal miner?
Sir, okay, listen to me, listen to me. I pulled you over, I sounded my siren like 5 times. You didn't hear me.
What? I didn't hear it once.
Listen, I told you to step back into your vehicle 6 times, and you didn't respond to me. Even people around you could hear me, like yelling at you. And then, I told you to step back into your vehicle again 5 times that you were going to be tased, but you never responded to me. No, it's the
I could never hear you.
Why can't you hear me? It's the federal.
At you.
It's the federal law that you have to hear me. What's the problem? Are you deaf or something?
My hard hearing must be kicking in. I have an appointment with the audiologist. Damn, I didn't know it was that bad. I was only doing coal over there by the farmhouse. I came over here to store it, and then I saw you pointing your taser at me. That's why I was trying to say hello. And that's why I was saying hello too. Like,
okay. Sir,
I couldn't hear anything.
I'm sorry
if I didn't hear your sirens. If I disrespected you, I'm sorry.
Okay, sir. You sound like someone that is really responsible. I'm just gonna uncuff you right now. Remember, you're not under arrest.
I mean, sir, I mean you're no harm. Detained.
Sure. So the reason why I was pulling you over was because you were driving without your lights. That's the only reason I was pulling you over. It was supposed to be a simple traffic stop, but you know, since you said you had deaf hearing, yeah, they were driving without your lights. Look at it. It's not on right now.
I think not to get those wrongs either.
Thanks,
all
deputy.
All right,
sir. I'm just gonna call a deputy for you right now. Medic for you right now, and he's gonna get you.
No, I've already called him.
He's gonna get the prongs out of you. So, medic's on the
way
right
now. Wrong.
You didn't do anything, sir. Like I said. Oh, thanks. Thank you, deputy. Like I said, I was pulling you over. Hey, cadet. Hey, medic.
Yeah.
So I just tased him. It was one-time taser deployment, so you go ahead and
I could barely hear your sirens. I heard an echo, like a whoa, but I could barely hear anything.
Lieutenant, we're gonna go 10-8 then. You guys gotta take care of.
I mean, you saw me stop right there in front of you. If you think if I was a runner from you, you think I'd stop at the steel mill and give my coal to the dealer over there?
I totally understand, sir. I totally understand. Just hang on, right? This is gonna be resolved right now.
Found
just
the prongs.
Hang on.
You don't know who I am, bro.
Lincoln 10, can I get a unit?
So
head to the
you're
bank.
Gonna feel a little bit of pressure in the slight pain. I'll count it down from 3.
Yeah,
3, 2, 1.
10-4, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, let me just bandage that up.
I don't need a white pole. Come on, check that out. Construction building.
All right, you should be good. Can I get your name?
Here, sure.
There you go.
Oh my lord, I gotta get this hard hearing under control. I was just doing coal over there by the farmhouse up the hill. Like, you can see them in between these two first mills. And then I drive down here and I was trying to make coal ingots to be able to do steel. Because I heard steel dealers are looking for steel
Lieutenant,
to be able to
can
create
I talk to you?
Trucks
yep.
for the world.
Yep.
I was only trying to do that. Not trying to do anything else.
San Antonio 1, show me 1076 911 to Phoenix and the construction site.
Alright, so I was trying to pull him over from the main MSL and I chased him to this place. I sounded my horn like 6 times and he never stopped. He finally stopped and stepped out of his vehicle and I asked him 6 times to step out and to step back into his vehicle and he didn't comply to me. And then he went up there, and then I told him that he needs to step back into his vehicle, or else I was going to tase him.
That man went over there with the he just went around the building. He's right there. He just hit my tire. He's coming towards us right now.
With the pickaxe?
Officer, no,
he has a shovel on him.
I do have a shovel on me. I did not hit your tires, though.
I have GoPro footage.
Why is he claiming you hit his tires?
We have footage.
Why is he claiming that he hit his tires?
Because yesterday, he stole a vehicle, right? And then
he said he couldn't hear me because
he stole a vehicle, and it was my vehicle.
Hearing,
but I didn't break his tires, and I've just been talking some smack,
so. I thought that they had a hearing aid.
Let me show you, deputies, let me show you. Please follow me. Can I please show you the tire?
Stay with this officer here, you in the suit.
All your tires are fine.
Look at my tire, deputy. Here.
Yeah, Walter, I didn't know who that was.
People back tire.
Oh, with you. If I knew it, what do you think?
Cadet 203 to Walker.
I kind of have to go to sleep, so do you think we can try to expedite this process?
Well, like the fresh charges.
So guys, you know, yeah, it's a day in the port, guys. I don't know. This should keep happening every single time. I thought that they have what they call hearing aids in picture signing, which is being issued out to those that have the hearing impaired or, you know, cannot actually hear real good. But he's telling me that he didn't hear me yell at him 5 times to stop or step back into his vehicle. Like, that's like, you know, I'm just, you know, I'm surprised about that, you know what I mean?
I'll deal with that later.
And I'm surprised about that. I yelled at him 5 times to stop. You know, that's crazy, but, you know, let's see what what's going on.
No, I'm not okay. Man. Man, this is what happens when you delay a really important appointment for hard hearing.
Yeah, how much you saw on steel for
it? Find that testing gun. I barely have any money. I'm trying to sell coal ingots to get enough money to be able to buy a truck so I can transport steel for people.
I have what?
Sand 21, I need an additional at Jericho Fuel. Respond code 3.
Where just give me one second. Deputy.
Oh, what
do you have? Can we mine around here? So I can stop calling you deputy. Lieutenant. My bad, Lieutenant.
Alright, sir. I'm gonna grab your ID from you. Do you have your ID on you right now?
Could we get another unit running into
the
Lubbock? We've got a bunch of 911 stuff
taser,
going on.
Taser.
Okay, good.
Can you give it to
Is
me
that...
again?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
I don't know where that jumper went. I think he left.
Alright, stand back. Let me just run your name. I'll be right back.
You want to see it on YouTube.
SD to EMS, are you on free?
That is affirmative.
It just pulled into the gas station here. We got a taser deployment.
Yeah, I heard from where I was.
Alright, 10-4. Thanks.
Yeah, actually I do. I do that.
He drove off-road 96 in a 70, so he's being warned for speeding. So, simply, he's just going to be giving a ticket for...
Can you say something again, Lieutenant? Oh, never mind. There you go, Lieutenant. Ready to go.
Alright, sir. I'm just going to put back your ID back in your wallet and put it back in your back pocket right there.
Okay.
So...
Thank you.
You've been known for actually speeding, but I'm not gonna be giving you a ticket for speeding. I'm gonna be giving you a ticket for that driving without your lights on. But you have to go check your ears and make sure that you get your hearing aid from the medic, so you could actually hear.
Mm-hmm.
Because
where?
You know, that was a serious case right there, and I'm gonna just let you know, because if you weren't, you know, impaired, you might have gone to jail for that.
Dang.
Yeah.
How much money is going to be the ticket? I only have 536.
Hold on. I'm going to let you know. Hold on.
No.
It's going to be a $200 fine, and I think you should be good to go.
Okay. I think I'm getting a paycheck soon from the coal company, so...
So I'm just going to take off the cuffs from you right now?
Of course.
Try getting in a car or
something. Get in my car.
Alright, there's your ticket.
There you go, officer.
Alright, good. So, next time, just make sure that, you know, you get go get your ES checked and get your hearing aids from the EMS, alright?
31 plus 1, just reporting that the prison is clear.
Well, sorry for the trouble, guys. Have a nice day.
No problem, you're good to go. Have a nice day.
Thank you for your service.
24.
Excuse me, officer.
Sam 21, to Lincoln 10.
Lincoln 10.
Lincoln 10, can you please respond to Jericho Fuel at their first availability, taser deployment?
10-4, being route momentarily.
Hey, thanks for actually coming.
Oh. Lieutenant needs your assistance.
Yeah, I know. Like, things just got out of hand real quick, you know.
Yeah.
And
he wants you to go over there.
How does my voice sound, Mike? Does it sound okay? Does it sound good?
It sounds beautiful, Cassie. I didn't slash your wheel as well.
I'd be advised the describe that.
Look at the bitches, I'm standing now.
Hey Jimmy, would you mind dealing with finishing up with this situation? This gentleman here had his wheel struck and damaged by the gentleman in the wetsuit.
Real fun.
Where's the gentleman in the wetsuit?
I've given him the option of either compensating him for the loss and taking a citation.
I'm in between the two guys, the two AI, or I mean, immobiles.
Yo, I can finally make my,
I can't move though. That might be a problem.
Where's he? I can't actually see him.
Yeah, can you actually get a god over here to fix this? But he needs to come and save this man or go to jail for damaging private property.
You mean he can't drive?
Alright. So, how much, how much is it to give to him? For the position?
He would need to give him $300 compensation for the wheel, and he would take a $250 citation for damaging private property.
Alright, 10-4.
Alright, okay, right. I gotta go over to the
car. Nobody's driving around in them.
He's only gonna afford them, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, right, dude. These people on this island are fucking rolling in dough.
What?
Are you making the island? You got it?
How do you get a god here? I think it's... is it A slash?
Officer?
Yes.
Officer, what's your phone number?
Be on the lookout for a white Dodge Ram in Lubbock.
Yeah, what's your phone number?
After,
hold on, sir,
It's 426-969.
I'm actually busy right now, hold on.
Okay, just take
10-4. White Dodge Ram, any specifics about it?
I do got hackers. It's right.
Yo, Casper, 1v1 quick scope me, bro.
Sorry, sir, I do not play Call of Duty.
I can't actually see him, I don't know, it's crazy.
Yeah, we all can't see him.
Then, yeah, let me see if I can get a, let me see if I can get, an admin here right now. If I can't, then, I don't know. This is just gonna go, sideways.
Bank of Freedom just moments
what
ago,
is sideways,
so probably is heading out of town.
Meaning, you know, you're gonna be here, like, hooked up like that, without going nowhere, for a bit.
Whoa, someone just threw weed at you, bro.
He gave you 15.
Drugs on the ground, drugs on the ground.
I'm actually busy right now, guys. Just, okay, can you guys just do me a favor and leave? I'm actually busy right now.
You're not doing your job, there's drugs around.
I don't need this, alright? Just, guys, just leave right now for me, okay?
Yep, I'm good. I'll give you guys.
Alright, is there a god here or something like that? Did they come?
No, I'm not here.
Free weed. Free weed.
Lincoln 10, Sam 21, was there anything in the head of that vehicle?
Do you think you could transport two seals down?
I'm not
doing that. You guys gonna need a ride back?
I'll do it. How much you paying?
If we head to a bank, I'm gonna be able to do it.
Alright, yeah, let's do it.
Sam 21, not at this moment, no. Not when you left.
No, $200.
I didn't see him coming into town.
10-4, you can just meet at Jericho Fuel. I'll just leave it as a higher up issue at this point and file the proper paperwork.
Better be standing now.
10-4.
So we can make, so we can do...
Here we go.
Did they come yet, or I don't even know what's going on right now. Jesus.
Anyone looking for some skill transfer?
How many coal did you have?
40.
Alright, let's go. Just keep that to yourself.
Oh man, I hit beans.
You should just fix his tire.
I know, I have a wrench, but, you know, the problem is I have to fix this right now, so...
to call. Yes, we're good, good.
Tyler?
We need to find out how much we're gonna sell it for.
Oh,
my wrench price is $450 a month.
Knocked out.
Casper, the friendly ghost. Casper.
Officer, would you mind moving your vehicle so I can back in?
Alright, hold on. Yeah, I will do that. Hold on, guys.
You just need to go to the bank and I can give you $250.
Casper, better get out of here.
Hey, if you need someone to transfer the skill for you, let me know. I'll get my truck right over there.
Okay.
What truck you got?
Flatbed. I charge about $300 per skill.
Well, shit. Whip your flatbed around. Let's fucking. I'll use you.
Okay.
Hey, should I just go to sleep if the gods are not coming?
I don't know if you go sleep and come back. I don't know if you're still gonna be in cuffs or something like that. But try that and see if you know if that fixes stuff. I don't know.
Officer.
Yes.
230. Is there available SAM unit to do a day 5 training?
Officer.
Yes.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Anyone?
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. All
right. So go to sleep and see if that fixes stuff, and then come back here.
Alright.
I'm up to, have 6 then.
Because right now, I don't know what to do. I don't think there's any, admin. I think they're kind of busy right now. Because I just called them, but, you know, no one is coming here.
He's going to take a piss.
Can I get, like, a repair kit, or...?
Yeah, I'm trying to see if I could give you, like, 250. I don't know if he comes back, because, you know, I'm trying to go back and do on patrol right now, because, you know, there's a lot going on. You know, this is a little situation, but if he doesn't come back, I'm just going to compensate you with like $250 and stuff, and he could be on his way, but I'm still going to wait for him.
Alright. I'm
still going to, I can give you a wrench. I don't know, you fix your vehicle and then, you know, you could go. But I'm trying to see if he's going to get back or not.
If you have a special availability, you need to message everyone involved. We're a little busy right now.
I've been on the force for this department.
How long I've been on the force? Is that what you asked me?
On the department, sheriff's department.
I've been there for like, you know, a year and a half now, I guess, yeah.
So?
Good at 230 for Sam 21.
Been shot at?
Lieutenant Miller also let me know to talk to the sergeant that is currently awake for my day 5 training right now.
Alright, kid, I'd be advised, today's day 3 training, you gotta come back for your day 5 training, when the day 5 training takes place. That'll be on Thursday or something like that.
Gene Miller told him that Sergeant would do day 5.
Lieutenant Miller told me to come in right now to get it done today.
Well, today's the day 3 training, and I'm just letting you know. Other sergeants are going to be busy doing the day 3 training, so I don't know. You have to come back on Thursday for day 5. Yeah, sorry about that. I was just trying to fix something on the radio right now.
Alright, hello. I can't move still.
Oh, man. So, you know what? Okay. I'm gonna give him a wrench. I don't know. I called the admin like so many times right now, and the guards ain't coming here, so I don't know what to do right now. So,
okay. Wait, is this your car?
Yeah. Are you a god? Or a semi-god?
No, I'm not a god, but I could jump in it and I could try and hit you with it.
What?
You said you're stuck. I could sit there.
No,
it's not kind of stuck. Like, he's somewhere else right now. We can't even see him.
Here, I'm gonna relog. I'm gonna relog him one more time. Very quick.
District 2 is really dead right now. I've only seen two cars for the past 15, 20
We can't even see him.
It's a guy that...
I can see him right here.
It's not me talking.
Oh, it's not? Who's it talking?
It's someone else. Like, he's like on the ground or something like that. Yeah, that's why. So, you know what? Let me give you a wrench, right? You've been right.
How do I use this thing?
You pick it up, you go to your vehicle, your driver's side, and when you scroll down, like you're about to enter, you're gonna see an option that says repair your vehicle, and then you fix it.
Oh, okay, my wrench is doing business.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, wrench, there you go. You got a blue wrench. And use that.
All right,
right there.
I'm just finishing. I'm just putting them back right into the container.
If he gets back,
yeah, nice.
Let him know that I called admin to the scene, but I think they're like busy. Wait, where's he? Oh, there you are.
He's in the building.
Yes, I can see him right now. Hello, sir. You back?
Yes.
All right. So, do you have that money for him?
I don't have any money, bro. Here, hold up. Let me check. I'll give you all the money in my hands. But give me 2 seconds.
Yeah, just
I have
give
$47.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Okay, you know what? I'm going to be helping you out by giving him like $250 I have so he can help himself. So, but just next
dude,
time.
Dude, thank you so much.
And yeah, sure. And next time, make sure you don't do something like that because that's jail time, all right? That's ground for jail time. I'm not going to be giving you that ticket, but, you know, just make sure because... Oh, because next time that's jail time. What the hell just happened?
I don't know.
What the heck is happening? Is my...
Yeah, I just saw that, man. Like, that's my vehicle, and, you know, someone just destroyed my vehicle. I don't know how that happened right now. Yeah. I don't know how that happened. Like, yo, there was a tank on my vehicle, like, right now.
Oh my god.
Man, you the coolest.
You the coolest officer. I feel so bad for you right now. I apologize.
Yeah. No problem.
What's your name, fam?
No problem.
What's your name?
Sergeant Jimmy Leahy.
68, there will be one.
So I don't know how to do that.
Yeah, let me just give my ID.
Alright, cool.
Yeah, that's my chef ID.
Oh, you said Jimmy, okay.
Like, is there a god over here?
No, man, there's no god over here, man. I don't know what happened. Oh, okay. Nice meeting you, Mr. Casper.
Yeah, fam. Appreciate that repair kit. You need a lift, homie?
Yeah, sure. If you could drive me to the sheriff's department, that'd be cool.
Gotcha.
Well, so rude.
Hey, Casper. Casper.
Yeah.
Come here.
Yeah.
Casper, come here.
Okay, so it just seems like he's doing that on purpose.
No, I wasn't.
I don't even know how he's doing that, but okay.
Fucking three iron ingots. So Red, you got iron ingots?
Alright, if you could take me to a garage, that would be fine.
Garage? Okay.
Yeah, so I can get out my vehicle. Yeah, I have like a lot of them, so.
Cadet 219 plus 2, we're going to be conducting a 1038 with a black pickup.
Thanks for doing this, my brother. Thanks.
No problem,
off
man.
Of West Street, west of Carmel Lane.
I could really just take you to the sheriff's department right quick.
Yeah, the problem is the sheriff's department don't have a garage right now, but if you could take me to any garage, gotcha, and I could, you know.
I'm trying to figure out where the nearest one is, because I'm not trying to backtrack.
Sam 212, Mark Evans.
Yes, go ahead.
Mark Evans, are you still with the with those people at the clinic. I'm currently 1076 to you.
Yeah, they're still here.
10-4, tell them to wait there. Try and just wait if you can. I will explain to the sergeant why you're late.
Alright guys, so I think this is where I'm going to end the stream right now. I just want to say thank you for everyone who turned up on my channel to, you know, watch my live stream and support me and, you know, for liking my video. Thank you guys. I appreciate you guys so much. You know, I love you guys. You know, from a boss to another boss, I love you guys so much. Just make sure that you guys are cool, you know, stay cool, be safe. And thank you so much, buddy. You know, make sure that you guys are safe wherever you are, and I love you guys so much. Continue to wait for updates on my channel, and I'm gonna see you guys later. Okay?
He's going to sleep.
Bye, guys.
I'm a 721 district.
Officer?
I think both the clients have gone off.